to the Richmond Coliseum for tonight's first round action in the American Arena Football League. This is Richmond Rough Riders taking on the visiting Carolina Energy. And the Energy and the Rough Riders played back on the first home game of the year back on March 30th. And Richmond took care of business 52-38. They want to repeat business here tonight against this fourth round team in the playoffs. So hello everyone, this is Jeff Butler, and I'll be joined by Coach Ricky Irby as we bring you this action, which we, Coach, had a real surprise earlier when we discovered that Atlanta Havoc lost the last two games of their regular season.
Yeah, that's a big break for Richmond Rough Riders now, and you know, got to take care of business tonight and make sure that we come out ready to play against a tough Carolina Energy team. But if all things go as planned, we'll be hosting that championship game. That's a big plus for the Rough Riders.
Yeah, you know that Coach Zimmerman is keeping his team focused on let's take care of business tonight. But what a great opportunity to have the chance to come back here next Saturday night for a championship game. And the other surprise is that the Georgia Doom are not in the top four. They had a money problem, even though they qualified as the number three seed. And they had been one of the two teams that knocked off the Atlanta Havoc. And so they were going to cause havoc if their financial problems were not as front and center as they were. So that allowed Carolina to come in as the number four team. Cape Fear moves up to number three. And that's the team that Atlanta is playing while we take on the Carolina Energy. Coach, yeah. One thing I was thinking as a key for tonight, that Richmond's had a 1 week off, and be curious how that extra week will work in terms of their motivation.
Well, there's two different ways you can look at it, Jeff. You know, sometimes when you're playing well and you're in rhythm, you hate to have that week off. But you know, I think it's going to help Richmond because we had some guys get banged up. You know, Mike Carey and Ellis Lancaster, especially some guys in the secondary a couple weeks back. And hopefully those guys have gotten healthy now and are ready to play tonight. And it was good to see Maurice Thorne step up a couple weeks ago in that secondary position and get those two interceptions and really help out the Rough Riders in a tough game. And looking forward to a great one tonight.
Absolutely. The starting lineups are being introduced here at the Richmond Coliseum. And if you're joining us for the first time tonight, you may have heard that Greg Hardy, who had been a staple with this Richmond Rough Rider squad, no longer with the team because he has signed a contract with the martial arts program, and so Greg is no longer there. We also have another new player to add to the wide receiving core, which is so strong to begin with. Robert Meacham is a fourth wide receiver that Coach Zimmer, real excited to have on board.
We saw a little bit of Meacham a couple weeks ago, and what he brings to the table, he's got great speed and great burst, and we saw him take a little hitch route and split the seam and take it the distance. And, you know, we have Brian Randall back at quarterback tonight throwing to him, and, you know, looking for those guys to hopefully they can get on page early and put up some points.
So we do see Brian Randall back on the lineup, but Robert Kent has been the quarterback as well, so it'll be curious to see if they give Brian Randall the nod.
That's right. That's a good point. That's a good point, Jeff. We'll see who gets the nod there between Kent and Randall. And, you know, speaking of Greg Hardy, did you happen to see his UFC fight the other night?
I did not.
Very, very impressive. I can understand why he signed a contract with the UFC.
Yeah, that's good money and hard to pass up.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah. Well, speaking of Robert Kent, he did pass for 235 yards 2 weeks ago, 17 out of 28.
Yeah, and I was very impressed with Robert Kent and his poise and throwing that corner out a lot, that like Richmond likes to do. And, you know, of course, filling in for Arvell Nelson, who was injured then, and that we've recently learned that he's moved up to the Washington Valor of the AFL. And, you know, certainly wish him all the success and all the luck as he moves up a little higher in the arena rankings. And you know, we'll see how these guys go. Richmond's a veteran group. They've shown the ability to bring in big time talent, and I think it's no surprise that they've gotten a couple guys back in here now that can really play.
Yeah, we talked about Meacham being added to an already talented core of receivers, led by Rashad Carter, who 2 weeks ago had 9 receptions for 112 yards and 2 touchdowns. And also, looking back at this game that they played against the Energy in the second week of the season, Carter had three touchdown receptions in that game. So he's in his first year, and he has shown that why Coach Zimmerman is so high on him. He leads the teams in receptions. And then, of course, the other, Jeremy Gowan, is a threat, as is Damari Jones. So when you add Robert Meacham to that, that's quite a foursome of receivers to throw to.
I agree, Jeff. And, you know, we've done every game here at the Richmond Rough Riders home games. And, you know, last year I followed them a great bit. And I really think the one position group that is the most talented on this Richmond Rough Rider team are those wide receivers. You've got four different guys that can really catch the ball, stretch the field vertically, and can take it to the house at any time. I see Greg Hardy down there dressed out.
Well, interesting. You're right. Yeah. He is there, number 76. That's great news to hear. He's awesome. Not on the roster.
Just hope Greg doesn't get confused tonight and think he's in a UFC fight. Let him come off the edge and get a couple sacks. These guys look ready. They look focused. They look pumped up. They look ready to go. You see Hardy down there leading the charge.
Yeah, what a great morale boost, Ricky, with having someone as talented as Hardy.
Yeah.
He missed the last two games.
And I'll tell you what that does, Jeff. That really validates this Richmond Rough Rider franchise.
Yeah.
When you got a guy who was on the cover of or on ESPN and he's on SportsCenter, and he doesn't have to be here.
Right.
You know,
he
doesn't have to play in an Arena Football League, but he thinks enough of this franchise to be here to play tonight. I tell you what, my hat's off to him and to this Richmond Rough Rider organization.
Yeah, it's incredible what this Rough Rider team has done. Came in here last year, won the championship with an undefeated record, and were on their way this year, won their first six games before going on the road to lose to the Georgia Doom. But here they are, having won out the regular season. They come in tonight with a 10-1 record.
Yeah, and undefeated last year, Jeff. I think they're the most successful franchise, professional franchise in the Richmond area, in the history of the Richmond area. And, you know, that says a lot. It really does.
It really does. You know, last year, Ricky, I was looking that the team won games in one game, 76 points. Another game, they defeated opponent by a total of 80 points. And a third team, they won by a total of 92 points.
Wow. And I'll tell you, the league is much tougher this year. The teams have gotten a lot better from what I've noticed, and the talent is a lot better. It's been an exciting season. And if you're in the Richmond area, you need to come out and check these guys out because they are very impressive.
Absolutely. Yeah. Great time to come on down here to the Coliseum. We're about 5 minutes away from the start of tonight's game. By the way, if you cannot get here and you're listening right now only on radio, you can catch a streaming broadcast as well. Just type in Fox Sports 1340am.com and then scroll down the page to Richmond Rough Riders and click on there.
Yeah, but you'll be in for a treat. You definitely will.
That's Fox Sports 1340am.com and then scroll down to the Richmond Rough Riders. We're about set for the national anthem, and we'll keep it here so that you can hear that in the background as we prepare to start momentarily. As we prepare, Carolina with a 7-3 record, Richmond 10-1, but now the national anthem. Well, we continue to have a number of stirring national anthems, and tonight was no exception, as we are moments away from the start of tonight's ball game, and a lot of excitement here in this Coliseum tonight. Richmond looking for its 11th win of the season and the right to come back here next Saturday night for a championship game that'll either be against Atlanta or the Cape Fear squad.
Yeah, and you know, talking about the Cape Fear, Cape Fear has a player that's a defensive back that played at Hopewell High School, a kid named Shaheem Simpson, actually the brother of Reason Murphy, that played for us at Hopewell. He's down there. He played at Methodist University.
Okay.
He's now playing for Cape Fear.
Well, it'll be interesting to see how the Rough Riders, with two very good quarterbacks in Robert Kent and Brian Randall, will handle the chores tonight. Brian Randall came on in relief of Cato. I don't remember his first name, but he played the first game on the road and then left the team. Brian Randall only had about 2 days of practice, and he came in for one game. And then Arvell Nelson played very, very well for a couple of weeks, and as we've been talking about, has landed with the Washington Valor, where in the first two games of his season, he's had 11 touchdown passes. So Arvell just hit the ground running.
He did. And I think it's a very smart move by Richmond to bring in two quarterbacks for this playoff stretch. I think you know, you don't want to have just one. And in the last few weeks, that we've had one quarterback on the roster, so you don't know what happens if you have one guy get hurt.
Yeah.
And I think going into the playoffs, having two guys active is very important.
Exactly. Well, the co-captains are out at midfield now. It's James Carter Sr., also Rashad Carter, and Deontay Hollis for the Rough Riders, and four members of the Carolina Energy. Number six, David Washington, he'll be the quarterback. Number 70, Daquan Murray on the offensive line. By the way, he goes 320 pounds on the offensive line. Also number 65, Christopher Kane. He's 6'4", 305, also on the offensive line. So they got some bulk up front. And then one other number, can't get that fourth number. And number four, that's Cameron Sullivan. He'll be a D-back, 5'8", 170 pounds out of Winston-Salem State. So it'll be interesting to see how the battle up front will be with the big boys.
You know, and I talked earlier about how impressive the Richmond wide receiver corps has been. The D-line has been just as impressive. You know, Keontae Hollis.
Yeah.
Those guys up front have done a great job. Greg Hardy.
Yeah.
Noel Clark.
And, you know, one key part of this game is T.C. Stevens, who took his last extra point kick. He has been just very consistent this year as a place kicker, as an extra point kicker.
Yeah, it's been a great weapon for Richmond, and hopefully he continues that success tonight.
All right, we're about set for the start of tonight's ballgame. Carolina Energy, just glad to be here. They thought their season was over, and then because of the Georgia Doom financial issues, they, as the fifth best team, now become number four. And so these two teams, the Carolina Energy will be in white jerseys, black helmets, and the Rough Riders in their traditional lime green and black. They'll be going right to left across your radio dial. The Energy kicking off going left to right. Again, if you're new to arena football, it's a 50-yard field. And there's a 5-foot wall around the entire arena that's padded, fortunately, and about a 10-yard end zone, or maybe 8 yards.
Yeah, and that end zone is curved, too, so it's you know, it's not a rectangle end zone like you'll see at most, you know, football fields.
Yeah. Eric Amaya prepares to kick off at a J.C. Smith University in Charlotte, North Carolina. And the kick is a high kick that heads across the about 3 yards deep in the end zone. Jeremy Gallen sprints out, and he is going to take it to the house. Gallen sprints for the touchdown. 53 yards on the opening kickoff.
That that's a way to start the game right there. Great blocking, great return, and all Jeremy Gallo needs is a crease, and he can take it the distance, just like he did in Michigan.
No doubt. He had one chance of falling down where one guy hit him, and he almost went down at about midfield, but yeah, he kept his balance.
And that was the kicker. If the kicker had tackled him, he would have gotten ripped pretty hard right there.
Wow, how about that for opening action here?
What a way to start the game for Richmond.
Stevens will be on to attempt the extra point out of Hampden-Sydney College, soccer-style kicker. Snap is good, the hold is good, and the kick is up, and the kick is good. Well, we haven't played more than 15 actual seconds, but with the running clock, it's about a minute, but just like that, the Rough Riders own a 7-0 lead, and Richmond will now go on defense, and we'll get a chance to see what this Carolina offense, it's been way back since the first home game of the year in which we saw Richmond take care of Carolina 52-38.
Let's see if TC can knock one through the upright for a point right here. That'd be big for us.
There's a running clock in the arena football with the exception of when you get under 1 minute to go. The 2 minute warning of college and professionals becomes a 1 minute warning in arena football. And so that's why the clock says 14:03. It only took Gallen maybe 10 or 15 seconds to run that. And Stevens kickoff. Doesn't have a chance, just wide left, and that'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. And we'll see David Washington, 6'3", 225-pound quarterback out of ODU.
Yeah, I was very impressed with David Washington the first time we played them. He's a tall kid. He's very mobile. He's very accurate with the football, and he can run if things break down.
Yes, indeed.
I'm jumping here. If I don't remember, this kid was tough.
Yes.
He was a tough kid. They knocked around, and then Carolina was actually in this game for a while.
Yes, they were.
Before the end of the game.
And you're listening to the voice of Glenn Thomas. He's our sports producer here as Washington takes one pump fake to the right, another pump fake, looking down the left side, throws wide, intended for Cameron Sullivan.
And, you know, Jeff, Carolina came out in a trips formation. That's the first time I've never seen an arena team not use a motion.
Yeah, that's interesting.
On the snap.
Yeah, that's a very interesting point. So a little wrinkle here for the energy. They try to trip up the Rough Riders, get an edge. Now, of course, Richmond, as we mentioned, that defensive front greatly helped by Hardy's presence at right defensive end. And then Defensive Player of the Year, Deontay Hollis, last year, anchors the left defensive end. And then the nose guard, Darren Lake. Three-man defensive front. They use a motion this time on the right side. Washington looking across the middle. It's caught inside the 15, down to the 13. Nice throw and catch. That one, Daniel Lee, used to play here for Richmond.
Yeah, that was a great play. That was almost an interception, and Daniel Lee did a great job of cutting in front of the defender and making that catch right there.
Daniel Lee started last year for the Rough Riders on their championship year and played a couple of games here before leaving the team. First and 10 from the 13. It's a running play, but nothing doing as the Rough Riders.
He
kept it. He did hand off, and Washington took it about 3 yards down to the 10 with a great fake.
Yeah, just a little zone read concept there. They're reading that backside defensive end. If he crashes down, that quarterback's going to pull it and get what he can around the edge, just replace him. And good call right there by Carolina.
Yeah, it really was. Got him 4 yards, actually. It'll be second and 6. Down to the 9-yard line. They can get a first down at the 3. Two receivers to the left and a third receiver now in motion on that left side. Washington. This time it is a running play. And another couple of yards for Joey Gass out of Emory and Henry. He's tackled at about the 7.
Yeah, just the same play. Just a little zone read right there. That time quarterback gave the ball and not much. I don't think they're going to be able to have a whole lot of success running the football right now.
Yeah, as we've talked, it's very difficult to pass in arena football when you're down inside the 10.
Everything shrinks.
So let's see what they dial up here. Coach Irvin Bryson, the head coach for the Carolina Energy. And they're going to call timeout here as there were only 4 seconds on the play clock, so they may have sensed a 5-yard penalty coming soon. So,
you know, let me get on that zone read. You know, what Richmond has not done has been able to put a lick on the quarterback. If you can put a lick on a quarterback every time on zone read, he may not. You're going to get the ball, going to end up on the ground.
Yeah, that's a good point. That's good. And, you know, and they're doing a great job, Richmond is. They're scrape exchanging that play right there, which means they're chasing the back with the defensive end, and they're scraping their linebacker over top, which is Maurice Thorne, which is interesting because he's a defensive back. But he's playing inside at the linebacker position. He's probably going to be a flat defender for the most part. I'm sure they don't want him in there because he's a run stuffer. But he's doing a good job of scraping over top and replacing where that defensive end was in case that quarterback keeps the ball.
So here we go. Third down, about 4 yards to go for the Energy, and a flag down as the ball was snapped.
It's like a false start on Will Dancy, number 77.
Okay, we just a word that this game not being broadcast on radio, but it is available on the streaming. That's Fox Sports 1340am.com. So a 5-yard mark off against the Energy. It's still third down, third 9.5, back at the 13-yard line. Yes, if you're telling friends about this game, just go to Fox Sports 1340am.com. Here we go on third down. Washington to the end zone, overshoots the intended receiver.
Yeah, that was great coverage right there by Ellis Langster. 82 just tried to run a deep cross. Andre Dixon, and Langster was all over him. Never to throw the ball right there.
Yeah, that was tough little window in there. Dixon got a hand on it, but it was just a little too far, so it sets up a fourth down.
All right, big play, first big play of the game right here.
And sometimes teams would think, well, why not go for a field goal? But we have seen a field goal or two this year, but usually teams will try to punch it in for 7. And that's what they'll do here on 4th and 9 from about the 13. This time, motion guy on the right, Washington back, steps up, fires across the middle, it's caught, but he's going to be very close to a first down.
I think he's got it.
And again, that was Dixon on the reception. Good tackle by Mike Carey of Richmond.
And they kind of ran the same play. They just flopped it to the other side.
Very big play for the Energy. And they'll have a quick setting play from the right hash mark with no huddle in the shotgun.
I look for Washington maybe to keep this one.
Washington in the shotgun. And it is a keeper. Off left tackle, he gets a yard or two. Stopped short of the goal line. Damari Jones, the first one to get a hit.
Yeah, Dwayne White was in there as well from the linebacker position.
Darren Lake might have had a hand on it. It'll be 2nd and goal from the 1. And so Washington this time up under center.
Going to sneak it.
He tries to sneak, now heads off to the left side.
Yes.
And Hardy made the stop.
Big time play by Greg Hardy right there.
Greg Hardy.
Yeah.
Just turned and twisted him down for no gain. And it's going to be 3rd down. They're going to say maybe inches away from the goal line. Maybe he got a couple of inches.
Quick, going again.
Quick play here.
They fumbled it. I don't think he's going to get it this time.
No, he's not going.
That's our guy Maurice Thorne right
there.
That's
right.
Wow.
What a play. Can they now hold for one more play? Thorne did the job there.
Yeah, Thorne needs to stop celebrating and line up. They may go quick again.
That's exactly right. Loss of about a half a yard on the play. Back to the 1-yard line. Rough Riders trying to make it 4 defensive stops in a row from the 1.
Yeah, second time this drive they've had a 4th down play.
The ball's at the right hash mark. In the shotgun, Washington. Gas in motion to the right. They toss it to him. And he's going to be stopped. And the Rough Riders have held. What a defensive stand for Richmond.
I tell you, Jeff, you can tell this is playoff football. Look at the emotion.
Yeah, Coach Zimmerman just ran the length of the field in excitement.
Yeah, big time stop right there by the Rough Rider defense. They tried a little quick pitch to the fullback. He couldn't find a crease, and then they was gang tackled at the 1 yard line.
You know, as we mentioned earlier, once you get down in that 5 yard line zone, it is hard to get in that end zone.
It is. And everything shrinks, and there's all the defensive players are within 2, 3, 4 yards, and there's just nowhere to go with the football.
Carolina had it first and goal at the 3. They got it down as far as the half yard mark and couldn't punch it in. Now up under center is going to be Kent, and there might have been a jump. It was. And even though they're going to go down and out, that ball's going to be, that's going to be penalty against Carolina in encroachment.
And Robert Kent right there is telling them, hey, we got a free play here. Let's take a shot. And he was trying to get Gallen and some of those other guys to go deep. And I think there was just a little miscommunication, but free 5 yards.
Absolutely.
You know, we saw this a couple weeks ago. Richmond was going on two a little bit. And I think this may be something that Kent likes to do. And great job by him.
So the ball's out to the 5.5 yard line. And Robert Kent does show a lot of experience there at quarterback.
And you know, the 5 yards is needed right there. You never want to be on the 1-inch line. Anything can happen.
Bob, absolutely. You know, when you're backed up like that, why not go on two? If you false start, it's a 0.5 yard penalty. Now, if they jump, it's a 5 yard penalty.
Gallen is the wide receiver to the near side. Kent under center.
Oh, Carter
dropped
deep
to the goal line. Has the receiver at the 8. And spinning out across the 15, takes a hard hit. Damari Jones gets the first down and survives a big hit.
I tell you, if he'd have seen Carter, he ran right by the safety right there. That would have been a sure 6 points. They'll come back to that, I'm sure.
All the way out to the 18-yard line. So the first down for Richmond. Each team now with one first down.
Nice to see Coach Stout back this week calling plays on offense.
Yes.
And this is the first game back for Coach Zimmerman as well.
That's a good point.
Yeah. Five-step drop. Going for all of it. Kent. Oh! Carter made the interception.
I believe he caught that with one hand.
I think you're right. Oh, my. What a spectacular catch from Rashad Carter.
What a talented group of football players these guys are.
Hey, you know, Coach, you called it. They went right back to it.
Yeah, they did. I don't think that with Carter's speed, his hand-out coordination, and really not only Carter but the rest of this receiver corps, it may be a tough night for Carolina. This Rough Rider team looks like they're amped up and ready to roll tonight.
32 yards on the pass play from Kent to Carter. And Richmond takes the 13-0 lead as Stevens attempts the extra point. As Kent went 2 for 2 through the air, and Stevens' extra point is good as well. Timeout on the field with the 6:51 to go opening period, and Richmond surviving that scare from energy, hold on to a 14-0 lead after a 32-yard touchdown pass.
And you got to look at this, and you know, that play right there on the 1-inch line is a big play. You went from being tied up now down by 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, that's a huge momentum swing. And, you know, no pun intended, but Richmond seems like they're playing with a different energy.
Yeah.
A lot of emotion, a lot of focus. You know, they're ready to roll. They're dialed in right now, and that's what you want. When you're in the playoffs, you got to be dialed in.
And that answers your question earlier about how would they come out with an extra week. Would they come out flat? Not so much. They're very effective tonight.
But you know, they needed that week. I think they needed that week. They played 2 rough games. They had a game. There was a fight. They had a game. They've been in the last 2 games. They were in battles.
Back and forth. You're right.
Back and forth. Guys got injured. Kerry got injured the last game, so he had guys to rest up.
And another thing, this team's been here before. They know what it takes to win. They've been to the playoffs. They've won championships. And, you know, that says a lot.
So here we go with Stevens' kickoff.
That looks good.
It looks like it could go. Oh. It just bounces off the right upright. Stevens almost had himself an extra point. He's done that several times this year. Instead, the ball will be brought to the 20-yard line where David Washington will lead the Carolina Energy out for their second offensive possession. Just joining us, they capitalized on a big fourth down play that took them down to the 13-yard line, and then they got another first down to the 3, and then 4 cracks at the goal line from the 3, and they couldn't get it in. And so now they'll try to get something going from the 20-yard line. It's a new quarterback in there. Christian LeMay sprints out to the right, fires, it's caught. Down the left side, it's Mackey, Devon Mackey, makes the catch near the 15-yard line, and you guys surprised with the quarterback change?
I was surprised. I thought Washington was a pretty good player. I remember the last time we played against him. But we'll see. That was a great turn right there by LeMay, so maybe they know something we don't.
And maybe sure he got hurt a little bit as he was trying to punch it in. Back to throw. Through the fingertips. Intended receiver Dixon had it in his hands and let it get away from him.
And that was another good ball right there by LeMay, just on a quick out route. Try to get your athlete the ball in space and let him do something with it.
It would have only gotten him about 3 yards, but still.
Yeah, but you take that one-on-one matchup, you never know. You kind of trust your receivers. You may break a tackle right there, and, you know, if he breaks a tackle right there, that's probably going to be 6 points going to that backside.
That's right. Defending on that right side is Malik Johnson, and then Ellis Langster's in the slot. It's going to be second and 10 from the 15-yard line. The quarterback, LeMay, fires it back over to the left side. This time, the catch is made about a yard shy of the first down. Mackey on the reception.
I think he dropped that, Jeff. I don't think he caught it.
I think you're right.
Yeah, that hit darted loose and it dropped down underneath the bottom, hit the carpet.
Yeah, they're discounting it.
That was a good little twist on up front between Darren Lake and Keontae Hollis. Getting a little pressure on the quarterback now, and see if we can keep that up.
So on third down and 10 from the 15.
All right, Harding, let's do something here.
Mackey split wide to the left. The motion receiver is Daniel Lee. And Perry Floyd, the receiver on the near side. Good protection, overshooting Floyd, and a flag is down.
Yeah, the flag was going to be on Thorne. He left that box early.
Left the box early, legal defense.
Perry Floyd was wide open across the middle. And it's... So Thorne is going to get the penalty called against him. First penalty against Richmond tonight. It's a 5-yard mark off down to the 10. So it'll be third and 5. And I'm sure that Perry Floyd goes back to the quarterback and says, I was wide open. So but this time, all three receivers are to the left side. They get it to Floyd on the left side. And he's going to be very close to a first down.
And a little jailbreak screen right there is going to set up another fourth and short.
Perry Floyd, 5'8", 170 out of Wingate University. First catch of the night. It's going to be fourth down, about a half a yard to go. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line. So far, they are 2 out of 3 on fourth downs. Let's see what LeMay calls out of the shotgun. Floyd in motion left to right. It's going to be a quarterback draw. And it'll depend on the stop.
Yeah, they're going to give it to him. Yeah, it's a first down. He didn't get it by much.
Yeah, his momentum carried over. He got first down on that one.
He just needed to get to the 5, and that's where they spot the ball. They won't even measure this. And so it'll be first and goal from the 5, and so here we are with where we were before to see if Richmond can dig in once more. First and goal from the 5. They stopped them on first and goal from the 3.
You know, one thing out of it, this Carolina offense has been moving the ball on Richmond.
They have.
LeMay in the shotgun, fires it on slant, and almost intercepted. And just kicking himself right now is Malik Johnson.
You know, I give Richmond a lot of credit. About 4 or 5 games ago, they moved Malik Johnson, who was primarily playing that linebacker position, and they moved him out to corner. And one of the games, he had 2 or 3 picks, and he's played really well. He's a big, tall, physical guy. He's got great hips. He moves well. I like him out there. I think Richmond did a great job with that.
You know, and that's coaching. When you see what you need to see from a player and go through his strength and you move them out to the corner.
Absolutely.
So we go second and goal from the 5. LeMay in the shotgun, looking right, batted down at the line of scrimmage. Hollis did the honors.
It's Keontae Hollis making his presence known. And you know what? I don't think that would have been a completed pass anyway. I think there was great coverage right there. That would have been a tight window to fit that ball in.
So it becomes third and goal to go from the 5.
Hey, Richmond's tough down here inside the 5, inside the 10-yard line.
They are showing it. 2:05 to go, opening period. Richmond leads 14-0, but Carolina threatening. on a third and goal from the 5-yard line.
Reverse, little wing
inside
trap.
Inside handoff to Floyd. Perry Floyd takes it down to the 1, and it's going to be fourth and goal from there. Richmond.
Looks like Hardy
has 2 guys down, and Greg Hardy is one of them. And getting up is Thorne. So it's Greg Hardy is the injured player. That's not good. And this is a great act of sportsmanship we saw 2 weeks ago, where opposing team will gather around the player and go to a knee in respect. And there's a hush here at the Coliseum as Greg Hardy, the most celebrated player in the American Arena League and one at Richmond, so glad to welcome back to the team after being away a couple games.
Yeah, you don't want to see this, you know, especially with this MMA contract you just signed. You know, you're looking at and you're finishing up the game. You don't want to see a major injury. We don't know. We try to get an update for you. This is the guy's livelihood. And got people tending to him. And we know hopefully he walks off, gets up and walks off the field, and everything's fine with him.
Absolutely.
They're getting him up now.
Yep. They're trying. He's a big boy.
Yes.
He's a big boy.
And, you know, Glenn, that does raise the question about the risk involved. His loyalty to the team.
Yeah, you got to give Greg Hardy credit. You know, he was in the NFL. He told the team he'll be here all year, and outside of other obligations with MMA,
he's honored that commitment.
He's honored his commitment.
Yeah, it means a lot.
And he is limping off under his own steam, under his own power, and the team, the crowd gives him an excellent round of applause.
Yeah, with that, he might be back in this one.
Yeah, it does look like that.
Noel Clark coming in, and Noel Clark is a capable football player as well.
Oh, yes, he is. He has when those games that Greg Hardy has not been here, Noel Clark has held it down defensive line.
So now, your energy, though, do you run this fourth down play towards Hardy's replacement?
Well, they certainly could, but I wouldn't try it.
I wouldn't try it. If you're the energy, you do a slant. I do a slant, get the ball on the inside.
Richmond's already proved you're not going to be able to run the ball in from inside the 5.
Yeah.
3 receivers are split to the left. Now one of them breaks out over to the right in motion.
They
the running
run.
Play.
And it's no
he didn't
good.
Get it again.
And they snuff it out again.
You know, Coach, you called it. You just already, they proved they couldn't run against the wide run.
Christian LeMay headed off the right side. There was no hole going. Rough Riders had clogged up everything.
Well, we talked about earlier, and I told you, Urban Coach, you brought a good point out about the front of the offensive defensive line of Richmond. That defensive line right now is whipping, when it gets in that 5-yard zone, they are whipping the offensive line
right,
from Carolina.
Right.
You know, you from the offensive line, being an offensive line coach, I tell my guys, when we get to the end zone, we better score.
That's
a mentality, the mindset. When you get in that close, we better punch it in at all costs.
And you look at some of those defensive linemen for Richmond, they're just stronger.
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to drive them off the ball. And they've proven it.
So here we go with Robert Kent taking over the controls at the 1-yard line. Back to pass in the end zone. Fires it out to the right side. Caught! Jones has it! He breaks away across midfield. He streaks towards the end zone. He gets in! Touchdown, Demory Jones! 49 yards on the pass play. And Richmond streaks out to a 20-0 lead.
You're seeing the different type of athlete now.
Yeah.
You're seeing a different type of athlete.
And I really thought the coverage wasn't bad right there on Demory Jones. I thought he was going to throw it to the dig and to Rashad Carter, but he chose to go to Demory Jones, and you pick your poison right there, you know, if you're Carolina. There's so many weapons for Richmond to throw to.
Yeah, you definitely pick your poison on that one.
And all 3 of those receivers have a touchdown tonight so far.
That's incredible. Stevens on to attempt his 3rd extra point, and the kick is good. And with 12 seconds to go in the first quarter, it's been an amazing 21-0 first quarter for Richmond with 2 outstanding defensive stands. And the only challenge, what is the health of Greg Hardy's left leg?
Well, you know, at this point, if they put up another about 28, 29, they get 50 before halftime, you might be able to rest some of those guys.
Yeah, that'd be big.
Rest some of those guys for next week. But, you know, you look how Carolina, as I mentioned it on the last touchdown, you went from tying it up to 7-7 to not punching it in. Now you're down by 21.
Yeah,
and
same situation,
and the game is getting out of hand. Carolina, as we mentioned earlier, was able to drive the ball down the field. just haven't been able to punch it in.
Yeah, that's a good point. You know, I'd like to see TC either hit one through the uprights or let us get a return. Them getting the ball in the 20, they're only having to go 30 yards.
Yeah.
So let's put this one through the uprights and let them snap it from the 5.
Perry Floyd is deep to try to return it, but Stevens does a good job of kicking it through the end zone into the stands. And with 9 seconds to go, his kick is going to go out of the end zone and through the upright. Another point for Richmond. As T.C. Stevens does what he's done maybe 4 or 5 times this year, kicked it coast to coast through the end zone and through the uprights at the other end, and earns his team another point.
And that, you know, that's huge because it makes it a four possession game.
Yeah, it does.
Four score games.
Or unless you could get a couple of 2-point conversions, but still.
Yeah, that's, you know, if you get into those situations, then that's winning. That's winning football right there.
Yeah, it sure is. And with the ball having to be at the 5-yard line as opposed to the 20, they will say that's the end of the first quarter. What a first quarter it was. 22-0, Richmond. And we'll be back. Here we go. The start of the second quarter in just a minute. We're back here at the Coliseum at the start of the second quarter, along with Coach Ricky Irby and also Coach Glenn Thomas, two coaches out of the Tri-Cities. This is Jeff Butler. We're here at the Richmond Coliseum and watching a very good Richmond Rough Riders arena football team try to defend their title from last year. And this is the first round action against the Carolina Energy. The winner of tonight's game will have a chance to play the winner of the Atlanta Havoc and the Cape Fear squad. And right now it looks very good for Richmond to be sitting right here next Saturday night facing the winner of Cape Fear and Atlanta.
Yeah, they came out with some intensity here, and they came out, and one thing that I pointed out, and the one thing that has been real noticeable in the first half, Richmond doesn't have that many penalties. In the last couple
That's
games, we saw a lot of penalties for Richmond.
Yeah, very clean quarter for Richmond right there.
That is so encouraging. They've had many unsportsmanlike conduct and personal fouls. But here we go from the 5-yard line. 1st and 10 for the Carolina Energy. And quarterback LeMay stays in there.
Uh-oh.
He throws it long, and it's almost intercepted. Making a beat on it was Mike Carey at the 15-yard line. Almost came up with it.
Yeah, great play by Carey, because I thought Dixon was open, and just a little late with the football right there, but he was open right away, and Carey would make up speed and was able to get back and make a play on the ball. You know, Jeff, talking about that 1 point for going through the uprights, it's almost as important to have that team snap the ball from the 5-yard line. You know, that one point is huge, but also having that's another added bonus.
It sure is. 2nd and 10 from the 5.
Blown coverage.
Overshoots a wide open receiver, Daniel Lee. And just a breakdown in communication there.
But he was also throwing off his back foot.
Yeah.
You know, he had a little bit of pressure from that defensive line.
So it'll be 3rd and 10. And one of the unique features of arena football is that the coaches can be on the field with their players. They have to go off to the side. But LeMay had a chance to go over and have a word with his offensive coach. And a very big 3rd and 10 now from their own 5-yard line. LeMay stands in the shotgun at the goal line. Another 3-step drop, fires it out to the right, it's caught, and it's going to be a 1st down. A very well-executed play that time to Devon Mackey.
Just about a 10, 12-yard hitch route, get to the sticks. 3rd and long, let's convert, move the chains, and get another first down. Great job by Carolina right there. Really soft coverage by Malik Johnson.
Yeah, the only thing that strikes me, guys, is that Richmond scored so fast and a couple of defensive pressures. The defense has been on the field for an awful long time for Richmond.
That's a great point, Jeff.
Back to throw, pumping, firing, overshooting the intended receiver, Mackey.
Yeah, Maurice Thorne did a good job there of getting in that window right there. He wanted to throw that stop, and Maurice was a flat defender, and he did a good job of getting in the quarterback's vision and making him throw over top and ultimately forced the ball to be a high throw into the stands.
So it'll be second and 10 from about the 16-yard line. The energy from Carolina going right to left. They trail 22-0 with 12:40 to go, second period. Quarterback Christian LeMay on in relief of David Washington. Fires it out to the left, flat, caught, making the reception. Number 9, Mackey, right around midfield, and Johnson made the stop for Richmond.
Yeah, just another deep hitch route right there, 10, 12 yards.
It'll be just a little short of a first. It'll be third down at about a half a yard. Right at midfield, which in arena football is at the 25-yard line, a 50-yard field. And now the Carolina Energy really need something here. And the first down catch to Mackey inside the 15, and he makes a couple of guys miss and get into the end zone. Oh, my, some juke moves from Mackey. And he made two Rough Riders miss.
That's just not breaking down. That's lazy tackling.
That's bad defense right there. That's just not giving great effort, really.
Yeah.
I mean, that's, you know, you give Mackey credit there for making a couple moves and scoring, but when the ball's in the air, everybody's got to rally.
Everybody,
you can't assume somebody else is going to make that tackle.
Two of our better defenders, Malik Johnson and Ellis Langster, were the two that he was able to sidestep.
Yeah, Maurice Thorne missed the first one, and then gave up on it.
Yeah, you can't give up on that. You're giving a team, even though we know in arena football, teams score in bunches, and they score quick.
Absolutely. You don't want to give them any momentum, you know.
No, that's right.
No momentum whatsoever. We have opportunity to crush a team or close the coffin or close the door, whatever analogy you want to use. You got to go ahead and do that.
Yep.
So 25-yard pass play to Mackey, and on the extra point, there's a 5-yard mark off against the Carolina Energy. They'll try it again. Try to close this gap, 22-7. Eric Amaya to attempt the point after, soccer style kick. Flags go down again as the extra point is good, but we'll see if it holds.
Second flag, roughing
the kicker.
Yeah, we got roughing the kicker, and we got offsides on the defense.
So two penalties will cause a decline on Carolina's part, and they'll take the point.
They may get those penalties on the
that's true. They'll get
the roughing. They may get the roughing. I don't know if they'll get the offsides.
I think they'll
offsides.
Just get
illegal formation.
They won't get that. So the running into the kicker, I didn't hear him call that. But anyway, 22-7 the score. With 10:44 and the first defensive lapse we've seen in tonight's game for the Rough Riders.
I mean, having a team score, your emotions are high. Even though you're up by right now, you're up by a good number of points. You know, you're up by 15. It still takes a toll on you.
Yeah.
You know,
it's a lot of game left.
There's a lot of game left. Anything can happen. You want to keep the momentum going throughout the game. As we tell God, kids, this football game is a game of emotions.
Yeah.
It's the game of emotions.
Psychologically, it's easy just to sort of, without realizing it, let up a little bit. After you've got three straight touchdowns, maybe that intensity lags a little bit.
Let's hope the offense here can stay hot.
Yeah, stay hot. And, you know, Jeff, you brought up a point earlier, defense is tired. Defense has been on the field a lot.
Yeah,
that's offense. Offense has scored real quickly. You know, those guys might have been gassed.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I mean, Richmond. We'll hopefully see at halftime the number of offensive plays Richmond has run as opposed to Carolina, but it's probably 3-1.
Yeah, every bit of that, Jeff. I would say it's at least that. Now we've only run four or five offensive plays.
So here's the kickoff, and it's going to be returnable from 7 yards deep in the end zone. Gallon streaks up the field. He's got a crease. He's got an opening inside the 20. And finally, brought down from behind, just shy of the 15.
pivot. Now let me ask you a question. Now, if he had run that back, where would the penalty have been taken from?
Maybe the next set of downs?
I don't know. Just keep carrying over, huh?
Yeah, I guess he'll keep carrying over.
Yeah.
I mean, you're not going to take the touchdown away, so. Or have been null and void.
Yeah.
You know?
That's a good thing he got that, especially since they're marking off 15 big yards because of it.
Then again, you know what? I think the penalty would have been on the field goal extra point.
Yeah, it could have been there. It's a good point.
So they'll spot the ball at the 22-yard line of Richmond following that excellent run back from Jeremy Gallen about 7 yards deep in the end zone. And they enforce the penalty from the prior play. Kent back to throw. He's hit as he throws a little too far for Gallen as good pressure put on Robert Kent.
Yeah, he took a shot there.
Defensive line for the first time has caused a little bit of difficulty for Robert.
Speaking of Robert, we got Robert Meacham in the game for the first time tonight.
Oh, that's right. So it'll be Meacham, Gallen, and Carter, the three wideouts. 8 players per squad in American Arena football. Carter will be the slot receiver in motion as Kent, who likes to take them all from up under center, has the ball tipped but caught by Meacham in a surefire tackle, but not before Meacham gets the first down.
That's a good first down there that Richmond needed.
Yeah, and great tackle from Sandy Chapman, but that is a very important first down. Down to the 17-yard line. Still plenty of time here in the second quarter. 9:15 to go. Richmond trying to get their fourth touchdown here in the first half. They lead 22-7. Kent, with Carter in motion on the right side, looks in his direction, overshoots him. Carter had a step or two.
Kent's been high a couple times this series. I think it's a little to do with the pressure getting in there. He's throwing off his back foot a little bit.
Yeah, he just needs to settle down and relax. He had Meacham on the curl route if he wanted him.
So Kent gets some advice from the offensive coach and heads back to the huddle. It's 2nd and 10 from the 17-yard line. Meacham will be split to the near side here. Gallen will be the receiver in motion on the right. And Carter also on the right. Plenty of time this time for Kent. Now finally can't find anybody and goes down.
Yeah, it was a clean pocket there for a little while. Nowhere to throw for Kent downfield.
First sack for the Rough Riders.
I'd like to see Kent pull that thing down just a little sooner and take off.
That's what I'm thinking too. I'm sitting here thinking, you know, this guy, you go to your first option, second option. By the time you get to your third option, it is take it down and run.
You got to have that clock in your head, understanding the pocket's breaking down on you.
Yeah.
He had a good little bit of time there to throw. Right. Just wasn't anything open.
Either you're going to take it down, or either you're going to run it or throw it away. One or the other. Don't take the sack. You know, you lose yards.
The loss of 4 on the play. It'll be 3rd and 14 from the 20-yard line. Richmond in Carolina territory. Kent back to pass. Looking, fires across the middle. Almost a great catch from Gallen. It was near the first down marker, just off his fingertips as Gallen dove for it.
I tell you, I really like the concept right there. They put Carter in motion and ran him on a deep cross and then tried to bring Gallen on a little intermediate cross right there. And he was open, just a little misconnection.
It's like a field goal attempt here.
Yeah, you bring the kicker in. You don't want to leave any points on the board. You got 4th and 13.
Yeah.
You got a kicker who's accurate enough and is dead center. Go ahead and let him kick it.
I like the call.
Got it, too.
Yeah. So Jeremy Gallen will hold for Stevens.
In the worst case, could
be about a 37-yard field goal attempt. We have a timeout delay of game. Oh, my.
Oh, that backs it up.
Cost him another 5. Now, Stevens has the leg, but certainly you don't want to get a 5-yard mark off when you don't have to. That'll move the line of scrimmage back to the 25-yard line. Add another 7 yards to that for the kick. He'll be kicking it from the 18-yard line.
Yeah, I don't think there's a problem here. It's dead center.
Yeah.
And I think this is going to be a good kick. Long to get the snap right.
It'll be about a 40-yard kick. It's up. Oh, it hits the upright. It bounds off to the left side. So close. And
it's a big hole for Carolina right there.
It had to be cold, as we mentioned. They only two scores down, legitimately.
Yeah.
You know, two scores down. You got 6:23, and the momentum now has shifted a little bit to in favor of Carolina.
You know, one of the things we've noticed with Richmond, you guys, is they tend to get a decent size lead, a nice little comfort zone, and teams tend to come back on us a little bit.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Let's see if we can lay the hammer down and shut the door on any kind of comeback right here.
And you know what? One good thing about this is that since the ball went into the end zone, they get the ball on the 10-yard line here on the field goal. They don't get it at the spot of the field goal.
Yeah, that's good. I like that.
That's huge. So with the ball at the 10, it's Washington back in, and that leads me to think that he was just hurt a little bit from that first set of downs. Washington back in, steps up in the pocket, fires out to the right. It's caught, and a nice throw and catch by Dixon.
Yeah, I see where they marked Dixon's forward progress on that, because he got up and moved backwards on his own.
Yeah, he's a little short.
Yeah, that's a good call.
Andre Dixon, 6 foot, 214 pounder. He's going to be just a half a yard shy of a first. The nose of the football is at the 20-yard line of Carolina. Plenty of time, moving down to the 5.5 minute mark before halftime. It's a running play off left guard, and not much traffic because Darren Lake was there to stop, but they did get the first down.
Yeah, a little inside zone and tough running.
The key part is that they'll advance the chains as the ball will be at the 24-yard line. And the momentum of the offense continues to put our Rough Rider team. It's been on the field for a long time defensively. Let's see if they can have a stop here with this fresh set of downs. First and 10 from the 24 for Carolina. Washington rolls to the right, fires a bullet, overshoots the intended receiver, but a flag is down. Defensive.
I think it's illegal defense.
Yeah, I think Dwayne Wright ran outside the tackle box there. I think the linebacker's not allowed to blitz.
Yeah, that's the call. Illegal defense.
And that was a good little stunt. And really, Darren Lake kind of made an inside stunt right there and kind of forced Johnson outside. But nevertheless, it's a penalty.
Yeah, 5-yard penalty.
So the ball has moved down to the 22-yard line of Richmond. First down, 5 yards to go. Clock continues to run down to the 4:40 mark. The Richmond crowd trying to get the defense pumped up here to make a defensive stand. Washington in the shotgun. Good protection, firing. First down pass inside the 15 again. It's number 82, Dixon, on the reception.
And right now it's been a tale of two quarters.
Yeah.
Richmond hasn't done anything in the second quarter so far.
Yeah. That first down to the 13. And this set, Carolina Energy, no slouch of a team. A 7-3 record, just two games behind in the loss column to Richmond. So, and as we mentioned, that game between these two teams, a fairly close one, 52-38, just a 2-touchdown differential. And that was at the first of the year, the second game, first home game. So here we go on first and 10 from the 13-yard line. Carolina with some momentum offensively has quarterback David Washington back in there after missing a couple of series. A running play off right tackle.
Yeah, zone read right there.
Down to the 10, a couple of yards, hard earned, and a couple of Richmonders there on the stop. Number 92, Noel Clark, one of them. I think Darren Lake was the other. So a gain of 4, it'll be 2nd and 6. Richmond has done a good job when Carolina has made it this far. The only score for Carolina was on a deeper pass play. Washington, quick pass out to the left flat. Making the reception is Daniel Lee. Makes one guy miss, but he has tackled at about the 8.
Yeah, not a bad job by the Richmond defense swarming to the ball right there, holding it to a 2-yard gain, and just trying to throw a little quick screen out to the flats. And great rally by the Richmond defense.
So it's going to be 3rd down and 4 yards to go. Yes, Richmond has had 2 great defensive stops. Can they make it 3 here in the first half? Washington in the shotgun on 3rd and 4. Inside handoff to Floyd. Coming the other way, he'll get in. Perry Floyd, well-executed play, and just like that, the energy are right back in this game.
Yeah, Noel Clark lost contain right there. He got reached by the tackle, and that opened that hole up.
And so with 2:28 to go before halftime, an 8-yard run from Perry Floyd, and we're 1 point away from a 22-14 game. And on to attempt that extra point is Eric Amaya.
Yeah, Richmond has been quiet in the second half, have not scored. 22 points coming in the first half.
Yeah, it goes back to that first touchdown that Carolina scored, where we had all the missed tackles. And that gives you your team some energy, gives you some life, it gives you some momentum.
The flag is down after that play.
And Glenn, you had mentioned too, and Jeff, you guys were talking about the lack of penalties in the first quarter. We've kind of seen a few more this second quarter, and it's biting Richmond a little bit.
Yeah, and it's changed the energy here. You know, you have to go back to the kickoff return that Gallons didn't score on. Then you had to go back to the penalty, which Nana had to back up 15 yards because he had good field position. It was on the 10-yard line. Then you had to back up to the 25. You know, as a coach, your play calling changes. You went from good scoring position, 10 yards into 25, and so now you had to make adjustment, and which could have gave you at least a 29-0 lead at that time, 29-6 lead. So now you're down and you haven't scored in the last 13 minutes, where you scored quickly in the first quarter. So we'll see here if Richmond can get back on scoring track, Jeff.
Well, Jeremy Gallen can be the spark plug that Richmond needs. He's done it twice already. He has a 53-yard kickoff return at the beginning of this game for Richmond's first score. And another spectacular as well. This time he'll try to make it his third great kickoff return. He's hit at the 8, though. A flag goes down. A much better defensive pursuit by the energy, as they have the energy here in the second quarter. Let's see how this penalty plays out. Maybe an offensive hold. Yep. Could be half the distance to the goal, and that's going to put Richmond back inside their 5-yard line.
Yeah, and you know, with this minute, 55 is a lot of time because the clock stops at 1 minute. But, you know, once the key here is Stevens' kick may be a big deal here. Because if you look at it, a Carolina kicker cannot get it to the upright from when he kicks off. So that 1 point will make a difference.
Yeah, they're going to have to go for two eventually.
They're going to have to go for two eventually. Yeah,
that could be very, very important. Let's see what Richmond can do with 1:45 to go before halftime. Kent, up under center. Real conservative offensive set here. And it looks like that got Carolina to jump. Free play here. And Kent fires it in the direction of corner. He makes the catch. Another one-handed catch. And they can decline this penalty.
Yeah, unbelievable catch by Carter there. And a great job by Kent. You know, he knew he had a free play. I'm not going to throw anything shallow. I'm going to take a shot deep.
And so they will decline the offsides penalty against the energy because Carter's catch puts the ball into Carolina territory at the 20-yard line.
Tell you what we have not seen so far is the tackle eligible play.
Yeah, James Carter, senior.
Good point.
Yeah, we've seen it about once a game.
You know Coach Stout's got it in the bag. He's holding on to it and waiting to use it at the right time.
So Kent, pump fake, looking long. He overshoots again, intended receiver. This one time, Damari Jones. Looked like he was covered step for step.
Yeah, good coverage there by Carolina. Really nowhere to throw the ball.
Just as well that one was beyond the reach. So it'll be 2nd and 10. The clock does stop now inside a minute. It's that 1 minute warning. And so with 59 seconds, the clock holds there. And the ball is at... Are they saying that there's an automatic timeout here at the 1 minute warning? It's not a timeout charged to either team.
Yeah, it's just to let you know it's a 1 minute warning.
It's just, yeah.
You know, what is key here? If you're Richmond, you want to score. This game has just tightened up a little bit.
Yes. You got to get that momentum back heading into halftime.
You need the momentum back. And also, Carolina gets the ball in the first and the second half.
Yeah. I think you got to make a play to Carter. Rashad Carter. He has one touchdown catch earlier He seems to be your best receiver.
We watched him going in motion towards the middle of the field, and he's been able to beat the safety pretty easily.
Yeah.
I'd like to see something like that again.
When these two teams played earlier in the year, Carter had three touchdown catches. He's got one already tonight, and he just finished hauling in another one-handed catch. Let's see what Coach Stout dials up here for the offense. Coming out of that official's timeout. 59 seconds to go before halftime. The ball's at the 20-yard line of Richmond. Kent up under center. Three-step drop, firing out to the left flat. Dropped. He tried to run too soon.
Yeah.
And that was Jamari Jones.
You don't see that very often.
No.
But, yeah, like you said, Jeff, he tried to run before he caught it.
And that, fortunately, the clock will stop. It's on a first down play, so second and 10 from the 20. You don't see any of the Richmond receivers do that typically. And so this time, Gallen and Jones will be split out to the left. And Carter, I'm going to look for him here on the near side. But now they're going to go the other way. It's the same play. This time it's a first down pass inside the 5-gallon on the reception.
And what they ran there, Jeff, was just a simple smash concept. And Kent was reading the corner. The corner bailed. He threw the hitch. And if the corner comes up on the hitch, you throw the corner route. That time the corner bailed. Great job by Kent throwing the ball to Gallen. And Gallen making a move and getting downfield.
So now Richmond has 47 seconds to work with here from the 3-yard line. This is where it gets tough down inside the 5, as the energy will tell you. Two goal line stands by Richmond has kept Carolina from leading this game.
Yeah, this is where the tackle play comes in. We either see a tackle eligible, or we'll see an out, a little Z out by Richmond.
James Carter Sr., the tackle eligible candidate, is playing left tackle right now.
Yep, this is the tech screenplay. If you notice, Carter switch sides.
Yep. But it's a running play to the fullback, and he gets
did
down
he
to get in.
I think he scored.
They're going to say his knee hit the ground.
Yeah, he hit the ground there.
You know, we saw that a few times a couple weeks ago, and sometimes it worked and sometimes it didn't. So.
Now, that's number 62 is not on our roster, so that we'll have to figure out who that is. The fullback looks like an offensive lineman in there, fullback.
Yeah, I think it's 52. That's
it's
Michael
52.
Williams.
Oh, Michael Williams.
Yeah. Okay, 52.
It's 52.
It looks, the numbers are hard to read a little.
Uh-oh, not going anywhere. The handoff again.
Timeout, 8 seconds, seven.
Eight seconds to go. They definitely will call timeout here, as that play did nothing. And so now it's third and goal from, they may have lost a yard there, back to the 4. Let's see what Coach Stout will dial up here. Richmond holding on to an 8-point lead here before halftime.
You know, you Coach Stout, you put the ball in the air.
Yeah.
You get two plays out of this.
Yeah, yeah.
You get two plays out of it.
Throw it quick. I want a quick hitter right here if I'm Richmond.
Yeah.
Something quick, something into the end zone where it's either complete or not complete. You don't want something that could be caught outside of the end zone where you can kind of get gang tackled and the clock run out on you.
And of course, if you're Carolina, you can pretty much anticipate no run here.
Yeah,
so
I wouldn't run it.
They will be extra keying on these receivers. It'll be Carter will be the slot receiver on the right side. Jones and Gallen, the other two, on the right. The ball's at the hash mark on the left side as Kent preparing to snap the ball up under center. In motion, Carter.
There's the screen.
Oh, it's batted down.
Can't throw it twice.
No, you can't.
Oh,
no, they've got it. They can make this a live game, and they're going to score.
Yep.
As Robert Kent had the ball batted back into his hands, he should not have tried to throw it again. It was picked off and taken for a touchdown.
Yeah, the touchdown will not count.
Because it's illegal, because you can't throw it twice.
Yeah, well, if they pick it, you can.
It's a penalty.
Yeah.
So the touchdown will count.
Just catch that and knock it down.
That's the worst thing you can do there.
Don't catch it. You're so far backed up right there. Just knock it down.
So just like that, a huge reversal of fortunes for Richmond. Knocking on the door for some cushion. with a touchdown. It's turned into a deficit now as Carolina is within 2 points of, they're going to just go for one here.
It's too early to go for two.
Too early to chase points. I agree with that.
I totally agree.
And it's been a tale of two quarters.
Yeah.
Yeah, it has. Three touchdowns the first quarter for Richmond and three for Carolina here.
Yeah, and Richmond has made more mistakes in the second quarter. And you took a team that was on the life support, and now they got life.
Yeah.
And this will be the last play before the halftime. There's no they're going to go for two after all. And they got it. They faked the extra point. And the fullback got the direct snap, number 25, Shelby, and we have a tie game.
They caught Richmond sleeping.
They did. And you know what? Richmond, the last couple extra points, have been sleeping a little bit, haven't been really playing that extra point tough. And great call there by Carolina. You know, they're playing with house money, guys.
Yes, they
are.
They
got nothing to lose. Nobody's expecting them to win.
Yeah.
They're not even supposed to be here.
Yeah. It's not supposed to be. And you got one team that's pumped going into the locker room, and one team that got their heads dropped. And there's going to be a lot of conversation and discussion in the Richmond locker room with Coach Zimmerman in the second half. And then we got to realize, I said it before, Carolina gets the ball coming up from the halftime.
Yeah.
So Carolina, Richmond hasn't really stopped them going into the end zone. If you think about it, Carolina should be up by two scores now if Richmond doesn't have those two stops on the goal line.
Right. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, the one thing I'll give Richmond credit for, they're a veteran group. They've been here before. Let's refocus. Let's figure out what we got to do, what we got to fix. Let's get it fixed, and let's go back and play Richmond Rough Rider football in the second half.
That's one thing we have seen is quite a good halftime adjustments from Richmond. They've come out in the third quarter strong most of the season, and that'll be Coach Zimmerman's task here at halftime. We're tied at 22.
You know, that's the thing. Your coach got to reevaluate at halftime, talk to the players. Quarterback got to shake it down, shake the head. Richmond has been inside the scoring zone several times and just haven't been able to score. So they got to figure out what it is and then figure out what they did in the first quarter and what they did in the second quarter, and don't do what they did in the second quarter, but go back to where they was at in the first quarter. So,
yeah.
So, Glenn, what do you want to do here at halftime?
We're going to take a break here on halftime. Yep. Those who are watching us online, continue watching us. Those of you who are getting ready for WWE NXT TakeOver, go ahead and go to the WWE Network and watch that. And we'll give you some few scores. When we come back off a break, we'll give you some scores and highlights from what's going along in Major League Baseball. And I got a couple questions to ask Coach Irby about. You know, I'm going to ask him about the T.O.L. Owens situation, about how T.O. cries about going to the Hall of Fame and then gets a chance to be inducted and don't want to go. So, hey, enjoy the break here, and we'll be back.
welcome you back to the Richmond Coliseum as we get set for the start of the second half, along with Coach Ricky Irby and Coach Glenn Thomas. It's Jeff Butler. We have ourselves a tie game. It's 22-all. It was the tale of two quarters, as Coach Glenn Thomas mentioned. It was all Richmond in the first quarter with three touchdowns, a 53-yard kickoff return at the start of the game by Jeremy Gallen, followed by a 32-yard touchdown pass to Rashad Carter, and then a 49-yard touchdown pass to Damari Jones, and two excellent defensive stands inside the 3-yard line on two consecutive set of downs. And that was Richmond's first quarter, 21-0 lead. But the second quarter, all Carolina. They scored on an 8-yard touchdown pass. They scored on a 25-yard touchdown pass. And then the third coup de grace was an interception for a touchdown right at the end of the first half, when Richmond was knocking on the door for another touchdown to go up by two scores. Carolina comes back and not only scores as time expires, but gets a two-point conversion on a well-executed fake, and the fullback ran it in. And so, guys, as you look at this Richmond squad that has to go on defense to start, what's going through your mind as you see them prepare for the second half?
Well, I have no doubt that they'll make some adjustments. They'll tighten it down a little bit, make less mistakes the second half, and come out and play well. That's what veteran teams do, and that's what good veteran teams do. You don't lose one game in 2 years by panicking, and that's the thing Richmond's got to do right here. They just got to settle down and play their game, and I think we'll see them do that in the second half.
Yeah, right now it's no harm, no foul. It's a score tied. It's a score tied. It's like 0-0 all over again. Halftime settles the momentum down. You come out and you play defense, you get the ball, and you go there and score. You adjust your game. You find out what you did and what you didn't do, and you fix the mistakes. And I'm no doubt that Coach Zimmerman and Coach Stout and that staff help fix the mistakes in the second half. There's no reason to fix the mistakes for the second half. There's no reason to hit a panic button whatsoever. These guys are professional. They played a lot of football, high school, college, at a high level. And so they'll be okay in the second half.
If you're just joining us, Carolina Energy come in as the number 4 ranked team, and they only got there because the Georgia Doom had some financial troubles. They would have been the number 3 ranked team, and they could no longer continue. And so a gift for Carolina. They thought their season was over, and they suddenly become the number 4 team, and they have certainly taken advantage of it in the first half, tying Richmond at 22. The other interesting point to me was how well David Washington played, the quarterback for Carolina, 5 for 5 through the air, 52 yards and one touchdown. And when he went out, we think with an injury for a short bit, his replacement, Christian LeMay, only 5 out of 14. But when David Washington came back into the game in the second half of the second quarter, you show the difference between these two quarterbacks. Not that Christian LeMay is a poor quarterback, but David Washington, as we saw in game number 1,
he's a difference maker.
He
really is.
He's a difference maker. Well, also, sometimes coaches get comfortable and they call plays differently with different quarterbacks.
I agree. And to LeMay's credit, he had quite a few drops on balls that he threw, I thought. Sure. I thought receivers could have caught some of the balls he threw. Yeah. You know, getting back to the Georgia Doom, so I didn't realize Georgia Doom was supposed to play Atlanta.
Yeah.
Had financial troubles. They couldn't travel to Atlanta.
Yeah, that's bad. You know,
I thought they were coming up here, couldn't come up here.
Yeah, I think that it would have cost them $20,000 to play in the playoffs.
Oh, gotcha, okay.
And
they didn't have that to play.
Hey, sometimes you gotta. This is a league where you gotta be financially stable.
That's true.
And Richmond knows that. I mean, let's be honest.
Right.
This is not the first time we had the Richmond. I believe back. Richmond Outlaws years ago. They was in the championship game, and they folded the week of the championship game. So it's not nothing those are listening to online. It's nothing that we here in the Richmond area have not gone through.
Right. That's a good point. And we saw that a lot last year, even during the regular season, where teams would cancel and couldn't get the finances straight. And hopefully they can get that together.
You know, before we go to Jeff, you know, for those who are listening to us online and listening to this game, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. so you don't miss next week's championship game if the Rough Riders make it. You can also follow us on Twitter at 1340 AM Fox Sports. We appreciate you for joining us. Give us a thumbs up. Let us know how you're enjoying this podcast. And so we just try to make it to you, make it better for you each and every week as we broadcast of Richmond Rough Riders football. So just let us know. Leave us a comment there in the comment section and let us know how we're doing.
Yeah, definitely. Give us some feedback.
And we hope we're broadcasting next week. We hope that Richmond turns it on here in the second half. They were led by Robert Kent, 6 out of 11 through the air for 197 yards, two touchdowns, but one very costly interception on the last play before halftime.
Kind of brought back memories for us, Jeff, in that state championship game where we had Reason Murphy with that big pick six at the end of the half.
Yeah, that was huge.
It gave us the momentum and gave us the lead.
Yes, how sweet that was. And Coach Irby, as the high school football coach for Hopewell High School, won a state championship. And what a year that was.
Just found out just 5 minutes ago or so, Reason Murphy was named the Virginia Preps 3A Defensive Player of the Year.
Oh, congratulations to him.
Fantastic. Big time for that young man.
And you had two other outstanding contributions that year. You know, you had Greg Cuffey at quarterback. He will go on to play ball at William & Mary. And then the guy going to Michigan? Or no, Indiana.
He chose Indiana. Ronnie Walker.
Ronnie Walker, of course. All-state player.
All right, let's get a point here and take the lead. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so. I think Stevens is certainly, as he's shown not only earlier in this game, he's done throughout the year, he's able to kick it through the uprights at the other end. This one's not going to make it. It's going to be short and returnable from 7 yards deep in the end zone. Taking it out, it's Daniel Lee. And Lee is streaking across into Richmond territory at the 10-5. He will score, and just like that, the former player for the Rough Riders.
I think that was Perry Floyd. Was that number three?
Oh, you're right. It is number three, not number two. It was Perry Floyd who scored the tying touchdown.
Dwayne Wright just didn't stay in his lane. He lost contain down here early, and I think that gave Perry Floyd a little crease right there at the beginning. You know, and Richmond is so used to TC or kicking that ball into the end zone, either through the uprights or out of the end zone.
They're not used to it.
They're not good at covering kicks. We've said that all year.
Yeah.
And now you got them down. They down by six. This is the first time in a long time that Richmond has been down at home.
Sleepwalking through this.
28-22. The extra point makes it 29-22. First play. So each team has a kickoff return for a touchdown. One to start the game for Richmond and one here to start the second half for Carolina. And just like that, Richmond back on their heels as they prepare to be kicked too.
Still no need to panic.
Nope.
There's a lot of game left.
Yeah, there's a lot of football game left. No need to hit the panic button. You got 14:05 left in this quarter. You got a whole other quarter. And we know in arena football, teams can score quickly.
Yes.
They score real quick. So no worry here if you're Richmond. You go back out. You do what you do offensively and start. And then you got to come out and do defensively. You want to get ahead.
Now, Jeremy Gallant been very successful on kickoff returns. As I mentioned, he had one kickoff return for a touchdown. Two others, he went into Carolina territory on his returns.
I'd say it's pretty safe that he's going to get a chance to return this one here.
Yeah, but if I'm Carolina's kicker, I don't even kick this to Gallant. I try to put it out in the end zone, do something, make Richmond drive down the field.
I think, I don't know if he can reach the end zone with it. He may have to kick it out of bounds on the sideline.
Or some kind of squib kick. But he's going to try. It's going to be way short. And Gallant's going to field it at the 2 yard line after the 5. Heading right to the 10. He's going to be tackled from behind, shy of the 15. So
good coverage.
Better coverage for two consecutive kickoffs for Carolina. And Richmond will take over shy of the 15-yard line. Their first possession of the second half. Now, though, down by 7. They led 22-0 and 29 unanswered points for Carolina.
Yeah, you know, you don't want this to be a big meltdown for them. And so if you're Richmond, you want to keep your composure. Don't do anything stupid and just play the game.
Got to get the momentum back.
Yeah.
Robert Kent gone all the way at quarterback. He'll call out signals from up under center at the 14-yard line. In motion, Carter on the left. It's passed to Carter.
That's what we saw early.
Carter made the reception at the 20. It takes a couple of guys to bring him down. Down to the 19 goes Rashad Carter, and a great first down for Richmond.
Yeah, sorry, Jeff, I didn't mean to cut you off there, but I was thinking that all during halftime. They got to come back to that because those safeties cannot guard Carter right there.
No.
You know, he's proven that time the safeties stay deep, hey, throw it early.
Yeah.
The safety comes up, hey, Carter's going to run by him.
And you coach Stout, you just you call your playbook. You don't have to do anything different that you've been calling in the first half. Just go ahead and keep calling and just make sure they make execute good plays.
Oh, ball batted in the air, incomplete. And we had Carter and Jones on the left side. Carter has three catches tonight. One for a touchdown. Jones has one catch for a touchdown.
And that's lineman. You just got to you tell your offensive lineman, make sure the defensive lineman get their hands down.
Yeah, yeah.
Get their hands down.
Those guys start getting their hands up. That's when you get that punch right to the solar plexus,
yep.
You know.
Give them a nice little punch there.
Yep.
His hands won't go up too much next time.
So it'll be second and 10 from the 18-yard line of Carolina. Three-step drop. Pressure!
Oh.
And going down is Kent. Back into Richmond territory.
Yeah, that's a missed assignment there. A breakdown of your Richmond. And line just opened up for the linebacker.
Yeah, he came in unblocked.
And the second sack against Richmond here tonight moves it back to the 24-yard line of Richmond. It'll be third down and about 18 yards to go for Richmond. First possession, second half. Rough Riders trail 29-22 in this first playoff game action here.
Three-step drop,
quick pass out to the right, dropped, and it was going to be a tackle-eligible play, and I think they had snuffed it out.
Yeah,
they had a couple of guys over there on Carter, senior.
And you don't have to get it all back at one time. If you were Richmond, you didn't have to get it back at one time. Now it's fourth down and fourth and 19. You definitely have to go for it here, and then you put Carolina in good field position.
Yep, you're right.
Now, you think it's – I mean, they're not going to go with the field goal. They did earlier in the first half.
Now you go for the first down.
I wouldn't kick it here either.
You go for the first down, man.
Because it was fourth and long when Stevens went. When he missed it, they got the ball on the 10-yard line. If they miss it here, it comes right back to this place. And flags go down. And let's hope at the defensive infraction.
That's offense.
Yeah, false start on Carter.
So they can take that and cost them another five. Back to the 19. It'll be third and 23. And Richmond not coming out with the steam that we had thought they might. Still early, though. 11:04 to go, third period. Fourth down, 23 yards to go. We'll see how the secondary of the Energy play this. Gallen will be the motion receiver right to left. Back to pass. Kent firing long, wobbly pass. It's caught!
Yes!
Touchdown, Jones!
That big-time play right there, Tamari Jones.
Unbelievable! He went up against two defenders and hauled it in. And Tamari Jones with a big-time catch, his second touchdown of the night. And just like that, Richmond's within a point of tying this game.
If you look at how he secured the ball, he secured it with his hand, but he also secured it on the defender laying on the ground.
Big-time play right there.
Big-time play. Richmond needed that. It was going to be bad if they didn't get a touchdown or get some kind of positive yards there. You know, even if they didn't score get the first down, it would better have been like a punt if they caught the ball there.
Well, the play of the game so far, 31-yard touchdown strike. High snap, placed down. Stevens up with an extra point. That's good. We're tied at 29 with 9:55 to go, third quarter. And boy, what a play that was from the 19-yard line under pressure. A wobbly pass from Robert Kent, but Jones went up around two defenders and made a spectacular catch.
Yeah, he made a spectacular catch there. It was fourth and 23. And, you know, he made a good catch. Did a good job.
And so now Stevens will try to do what he does most of the time, and that's kick it out of the end zone.
Now, if you Stevens, you want to kick it through the uprights and get the extra point, take the lead. You don't want to kick it to the end zone. You want to kick it to the uprights and get the
point.
Well, I said out of the end zone. So
either one of the two.
One of the two.
Just don't leave it in play.
One of the two. Just don't leave it in play.
Absolutely. And most of the time, 95% of the time, he'll either split the uprights or kick it out of the end zone. But as we saw on the first play of the second half, He kicked it short. It was caught 7 yards deep in the end zone and returned for a touchdown. Richmond does not get a lot of practice on kickoff returns, and that's because of a kick just like this.
That's good.
Stevens kicks it through the uprights at the other end.
That's big time right there.
Big time extra point. It gives Richmond the 1-point lead, and it puts Carolina on the 5-yard line.
Now we got to have a defensive stop right here.
A defensive stop. We said it all. We've been saying it all the time, Coach and Jeff, that Stevens has really helped this team. He's the guy that allows them to get points, extra points when you need them. And now they backed up. Now Carolina has to drive the length of the field.
Huge play. So from the 5-yard line, David Washington comes back into the game where he is 5 out of 5 through the air. 6'3", 225-pounder out of ODU. He stands at his goal line in the shotgun. Looking left, fires incomplete, his first incompletion of the night intended for number 82, Dixon.
Yeah, Washington just rushed the throw a little bit, threw a little low. I don't think Dixon was ready for it.
Nah, he wasn't ready, Bill.
So a little miscommunication, and it'll be 2nd and 10 from the 5. Malik Johnson, the corner on the left side. In the slot is Ellis Langster. Free safety looks to be Thorne, where he's kind of a middle linebacker type position. On 2nd and 10, firing outlet. Good defense by Johnson, knocking it away from the intended receiver, Mackey.
Yeah, that was almost picked off there, too.
It was. I tell you, he's made a couple on those in the recent weeks, on those deep hitch routes. Yeah, the first half, we saw Johnson playing a lot of soft coverage, giving up that 10-yard hitch. Right there, he didn't give it.
So the defensive intensity has picked up here. And the crowd is encouraging the Rough Riders on a big 3rd and 10 from the 5-yard line. David Washington, the Carolina quarterback, in the shotgun, looking long, firing down the left sideline, incomplete. Do we see a flag? No.
That was good. That was good defense
good
right
call.
There.
They were both hand fighting right there. I think that's a good no call.
Number 11, Mike Carey, stride for stride with the intended receiver, Dixon.
And it's good to see Mike Carey back after his injury two weeks ago.
Yeah. So it's 4th and 10. And the crowd cheering on the Rough Riders.
Big play in the game right here.
4th down. 10 yards to go from the 5-yard line. Washington in the shotgun. Oh, no, there's going to be a flag. And that's going to hurt.
That's Hardy back in the game, right?
Yeah, Hardy's back in the game.
But the flag's going to go against Darren Lake, who misinterpreted the snap. He jumped too soon.
He almost timed it perfect, though.
He didn't need to do that on 4th and 10. Now it's going to be – now if Thorne's going to get himself
– no, we don't need any of that. You just let them get the 5-yard penalty. It's still 4th and 5. You know, and Zimmerman is hot about that because the snap was over the quarterback's head.
So the 5-yard mark off against Richmond makes it 4th and 5 from the 10. Big penalty there. But let's see if Richmond can stop them here. Washington has Daniel Lee in the slot. He'll be in motion on the right side. Washington looking in his direction. It's caught. First down for Carolina across the 20. Langster on the tackle.
Yeah, I think Ellis tried to go over the left side. If he just kind of undercuts that a little bit, I think he may be able to make a play on that ball. Nevertheless, good throw and catch. Good conversion for Carolina.
Yeah, good Carolina. That penalty came back and bit Richmond in the butt.
So from the 22-yard line, a fresh set of downs for Carolina. It's a running play off left. Flag goes down. Off left guard goes the fullback, Joey Gass. And let's see how this flag shakes out. 6:56 to go as the clock stops with the penalty.
Yeah, as legal defense, Richmond was trying to switch their corners. I don't think they got where they needed to be in time.
So that's the 2nd illegal defense against Richmond tonight. And they'll take that penalty rather than the short gain. And it'll still remain 1st down and 5 yards to go for Carolina. They're down by just a point, 30-29. We were tied at halftime at 22. Richmond led after one quarter, 22-0. Here comes Carolina now on first and five from the 23-yard line of Richmond. It's a running play, and it's Floyd off the left side. Nice wrap-up tackle that time by Dwayne White from Shaw University, and a short gain of a couple of yards for Floyd, and an injured player. Slow to get up.
Mike Carey.
Looks like he's going to be all right.
They've tried that little wing reverse two or three times now, and had success with it once. At that time, they didn't get much, and the first time they ran it, they didn't get much. So, good job by Richmond.
All right, this is four down territory for sure in arena football. It's only really second down now and 4 yards to go because of that 5-yard penalty. Washington, plenty of time to throw. Now he shakes off one would-be tackler. He just fires it incomplete. A flag goes down, though. In the secondary, let's see where that penalty will go. As the officials talk, Washington had protection finally break down as the receivers were covered.
They're waving it off.
Yeah, that's good. I thought he may have called pass interference. I didn't know what else he could have called.
Yeah, I didn't know what else he could have called either.
I definitely don't think it was pass interference.
No way. So it'll be third down and four. Good pressure by that defensive front.
Yeah, that was. Great job. That was great pressure. That was great coverage, too.
Let's see how Greg Hardy does on this. Playing back in the game with a hurt leg. It's a running play. Yes, not much going, a half a yard gain, and a good tackle that time by big number six, White.
Yeah, great job by Dwayne White.
So it'll be fourth down, and about 3.5 yards to go. And Richmond has
another big fourth down right here.
Had some key fourth down plays here. And let's see if they can make their third fourth quarter stop. Fourth down stop.
Watch the ball.
Washington steps up in the pocket, fires long, overshoots the intended receiver. No flags down. The ball goes over on down.
That was a good defensive stand for Richmond.
Yeah.
They needed that. Now the offense has to come out and get the possession, and you're back up. Offense comes and scores, you're to a two-possession game if they get a touchdown here.
Yeah, that's great. That'd be big for them. That was a great job by the defensive line of collapsing the pocket right there. Great push up front in the middle. Great job by the two ends of just collapsing the pocket. Stayed in your rush lanes. You don't want to give Washington a chance to escape somewhere, because he can definitely hurt you with his legs.
That pass was intended for Daniel Lee across the middle. And great defensive stop for Richmond. It gives the ball at their own 22-yard line. Quick pass behind, but a super catch from Jones to reach back to make the catch on a pass that was behind him. And a good pickup of about six for Richmond on first down into Carolina territory.
Yeah, there's a penalty here, too. I think it's illegal defense. I think I'd take the penalty. It's either going to be second and four or first and five.
Yeah, I think that you're right. That's what they're going to do. They'll take the penalty. It'll still remain first down. The first illegal defense against Carolina called tonight.
I really like what Richmond has Carter going in motion in the middle there. I think it's a mismatch him on the safety.
Yeah.
I think if they can take advantage of that every down.
Yeah, Carter's got,
here we go again. He's got him coming in motion in the middle.
A couple of inches. Carter in motion on the left side. And a pass out to the left flat. Jones had Carter blocking for him that time, but Jones got the first down. That's the most important thing. Down to the 17-yard line, and Richmond getting in some rhythm here offensively.
Yeah, a little quick screen out to the edge and let your playmakers make some damage in space.
Clock down to 3:50 to go, third period. Richmond leading 30-29. There's a penalty.
There's Carter.
And
on
it's
the
a touchdown, Carter! And the flag will go against Carolina.
Hey, way to respond.
Richmond, great job.
17-yard scoring pass to Rashad Carter. His second touchdown catch of the night, a perfectly thrown ball. And just like that, Richmond has a 7-point lead, and the extra point could make it 8. Robert Kent with his third touchdown pass of the night. Stevens on to attempt another point after. Gallon to hold. The hold is down. Stevens' kick is perfect.
Yep. Perfect snap, perfect hold, perfect kick.
So Richmond takes an 8-point lead. 37-29 with 3:16 to go, third period. And guys, this looks like this could be a barn corner down to the final minutes.
Yeah, it does look that way. Richmond defense actually came out second half and was one of the few times, another time where they held Carolina, and you can see the air starting to come out of Carolina.
And let's hope it continues to come out of them.
You know, that's what veteran teams do. That's what good veteran teams do. They settle down, they don't panic, they make plays. Great answer. That's a great answer by Richmond right there. There's the last defensive drive or possession and the last offensive drive. I really think they can take advantage of Carter on the safety.
You're onto something there. Now Stevens split the uprights at the other end on his last kick.
This will be a big one. Put him up 9.
He's done it twice tonight. He'd like to make it the trifecta here. He approaches. Shot that goes left of the upright,
yeah,
so
hooked that one.
It will bring the ball up to the 20, but more importantly, it doesn't give their kickoff returner a chance to bring it out. So Carolina will start from their own 20, down by 8. And David Washington did not have the success that last time that he did in the first half. Let's see if the Richmond defense can, without penalties, push him back here. They have two receivers to the right and one to the left. They're not going to go with a motion on this play. Washington in the shotgun. Steps up in the pocket. Now fires. Caught. Across the middle. First down. Making the catch. Number 9, Mackey.
Yeah, Carolina had two guys in the same spot right there, and no Richmond guys there.
Yeah, that's unusual.
Yeah.
So a gain of about 11 on the play, down to the 18-yard line.
And Hollis had good pressure there off the edge, and Washington did a good job of stepping up in the pocket. Need a little more vertical push up the middle right there, so there's no pocket for him to step up into.
This time, Dixon will be in motion on the left side. But it's a running play, and going nowhere. Number 37, Gass, ran out of gas because of the defensive pressure from Greg Hardy.
If you're Carolina, these running plays in the second half have not worked as they did, like they did in the first. So, you know, you might want to change as you get coach. You look at your offensive line and
I agree.
Change some of this stuff around.
Hey guys, what tenacity Greg Hardy's playing with? He's playing with a decided limp. But he's a gamer, and he's in there, giving it his all. Quick pass out to the left flat is caught, and he'll be down with the catch. Will Mackey be at the 15-yard line, a short gain of about 3?
You know, Greg, think about it. You got to look at it this way. Greg Hardy is back on a winning football team.
Yeah.
You know, and he's playing this game. He genuinely likes the guys here. You know, so he's going to give these guys the best he can, and you never know what he's auditioning for. I mean, we just had a rough ride to go to the New York Giants, so you never know what else. So what else am I playing for? And people just want to see if he's rehabilitated.
Yep, good point. So here we go on third down, 7 yards to go. Towards the end zone, Washington has a touchdown. He had the open receiver on the far side, and it was Mackey. He made the catch against Langster.
Yeah, he was wide open. I don't know if it was a blown coverage or he was wide open in the corner of the end zone.
And just like that, it's back to a 2-point game, 37-35, with 45 seconds to go before the third quarter ends.
I tell you, they're gonna kick it here, Jeff. Let's watch for the fake again.
Yeah, exactly. They got to be alert to the It was number 25 from this fullback position who got the two-point conversion last time, but I think they're going to go for just the one here. And the extra point is good. So with 24 seconds to go, we're in a nail-biter here, a one-point game, 37-36, Richmond on top.
Yeah, Richmond's been a little confused in the secondary a few times tonight as far as what their coverage was. That time that hurt them, cost them a touchdown.
David Washington connecting with Devon Mackey. And so that quiets the crowd somewhat. We were 22-22 at halftime, and on the opening kickoff, Richmond's crowd were shocked even more when Carolina took it coast-to-coast, 57-yard kickoff return for a touchdown. And they led 29-22. But since then, Richmond has stormed back to retake the lead, and only to find that lead shrinking back down to one.
I say, if we can get a couple blocks here, I think Gallen might be able to hit something big here.
Yeah, Gallen in the first half was spectacular on kickoff return. Now, the last two times, the defense of the Energy was really good on the kickoff. And this kick is heading left, and it's going to be returnable. Gallen is hit before the 10-yard line, though, and Richmond will be backed up somewhat. Another good defensive series on the kickoff by the Energy. And they'll spot the ball at the 12-yard line. So 16 seconds to go, time for one or two plays. Probably one. And the offense.
They may not get one at all here, Jeff.
It looked like the Coach Dow, the Coach Dow doesn't want it.
Oh, you're right. You're right. They'll be content to let the clock run off, and so we will have a 1 minute break and we'll be back.
Yeah, while we take this 1 minute break, give you a couple of updates on some scores, what's going on. Those of you watching soccer out there, who are watching the World Cup, and those of you watching Major League Baseball, the Baltimore Orioles continue their woes today, losing to the Florida Marlins. You heard that earlier on Fox Sports Radio 1340 AM and 96.9 FM. The Marlins defeated the Baltimore Orioles 5-4. The Blue Jays defeated the Nationals in a league 2-0 today. Blue Jays got that in the second inning. Boston Red Sox and the Seattle Mariners are scoreless. The Giants and the Dodgers lead the Giants 1-0 top of the third. St. Louis Cardinals lead the Cubs 2-0 in bottom of the second. The New York Yankees got a win today over the Tampa Bay Rays 4-1. The Houston Astros, the defending World Series champions, get the win over Kansas City 10-2. The Athletics defeated the Angels today 6-4. Philly defeated the Milwaukee Brewers 4-1. Late game is the New York Mets taking on the Arizona Diamondbacks. Those of you that enjoy WNBA scores, the Atlanta Dream are losing to the Indiana Fever 60-86, as well as the Minnesota Lynx looking back to get back in their winning ways, have a large commanding lead over the New York Liberty 49-13. World Cup action, we have France who defeated Australia today 2-1, and Argentina and Iceland ended up in a tie, which is a shocker there in the World Cup League, with Messi not being able to score for Argentina, and Argentina and Iceland have a tie.
Well, as you were talking baseball for a while, it reminded me, since a lot of our listeners are from the Tri-Cities, kudos to Prince George High School. They, if I'm not mistaken, Len, both the boys and the girls team won state championships.
Yeah, the boys and girls team both won at the same time. Was the first team in Virginia history to do so. But then another school, Pace High School, did it the same day in 3A as well. So, so you had boys, girls, and boys baseball and girls softball both win titles on the same day for Prince George. Congratulations.
And definitely big-time congratulations. And both of those teams have been knocking on the door for the last few years, and it's good to see them break through the door and win those championships. Great for Mickey Roberts down there, and as well as the softball team.
Yeah.
Great job.
Neil and Chandler out there, you know, for years, Coach Pat Wagenspack had the Prince George softball team rolling for years. And he may not say it, but he is the second winningest coach in softball in the state of Virginia, Coach Pat Wagenspack. But Neil and Chandler took over and took those girls to a state title.
Yeah, great job.
And the Hopewell High School boys baseball team made it into the regionals.
They won the regionals.
They won the regionals, and they lost to the future state champions.
Spotsylvania.
Right. So there's a lot of big baseball going on in the Tri-City area.
Big time players.
A couple players went to Division One. Some players going to the University of Richmond, West Virginia. So there's a lot of good players here in the Tri-City area. Go out and check out some of your local high school sports, man. High school sports in the area, if you're here in the Virginia area, Tri-City, Richmond, Virginia area, is big time high school sports. We've got a couple state champions out of football, Hopewell and Highland Springs, and Dinwiddie's always knocking on the door. Got some up-and-coming teams this year. Elsie Bird, who's the new transition coach with Troy Taylor, going over there. And so you got a lot of teams in the area that will be doing a lot of good things in the fall.
Absolutely.
You know, all right, we're almost set for the start of the fourth quarter. Along with Coach Ricky Irby, Coach Glenn Thomas, it's Jeff Butler, Richmond Rough Rider football, the first round playoffs of the American Arena League.
All right, how does Richmond respond here?
With a one-point lead, as we start the fourth quarter, Richmond has the ball on their own 12-yard line, going left to right. Robert Kent all the way at quarterback. He'll have receivers Carter and Robert Meacham split to the far side. And in motion, Gallen on the right side. Kent back. He's going to be sacked. Robert Kent goes down before he got the ball off to Meacham. The officials whistled it dead back at the 7-yard line. Third time Kent's been sacked tonight.
Yeah, you don't see that very often. This Richmond Rough Rider offensive line is usually a pretty stout group, and you usually don't see quarterbacks really getting touched.
Yeah, when Arvell Nelson was here, he would take his snaps from the shotgun. And I'm surprised that Kent doesn't, because it would buy you some time.
Yeah. All right, here's Carter in the middle, going motion again.
Second down, 15 yards to go. They got him to jump in a free play here. Kent will throw long. Nobody back there, though. And the ball is intercepted at the 2, but the flag will go against Carolina for encroachment.
Go ahead and hit him and strip the ball. Yeah, the play's going to be dead anyway. So go ahead, go for that strip right there and see if you can't pick up one. You know, I see what Kent's doing there. He's trying to go deep. Hey, he had Robert Meacham wide open right there in the flats. Hey, throw that thing to him.
Absolutely.
He may make a guy miss. He may pick up 8-10 yards. He may break it for a touchdown, you know.
You got to look down there to see if there's anybody there.
Right, right.
So the 5-yard mark off against Carolina moves it out to about the 12-yard line. 37-36, Richmond leading by a point. Meacham and Carter are the receivers to the near side. In motion on the far side, Gallen. Kent, five-step drop, looking long, overshooting the intended receiver, Gallen, streaking towards the corner on the right side. And it'll be third down and about 10 yards to go for Richmond. Clock, not a factor yet. We just started this fourth quarter. It was 22 all at halftime. These two teams played in the second game of the year, and Richmond won by 14, 52-38. Carolina went on to a 7-3 overall record, and Richmond 10-1. Robert Kent up under center from the 12. Third and 10, five-step drop. Fires out to the left, it's caught. Can Meacham get it? He's going to be a yard shy of a first, but this is four down territory.
Oh, yeah.
And Meacham will be down at the 20-yard line, a full yard shy of a first down. And as Coach Stout talks with Robert Kent,
it's a big play here for Richmond.
Richmond has only two running plays in the first half for no yards, so it's probable that they'll throw it here. One-step drop, pass complete,
Good job.
The first down catch to Carter.
Hey, that's really strong hands right there.
You know, that is it. He's got the strongest hands, I think, of all the receivers. And Carter got about 5 yards on the play. Most important first down for Richmond on that fourth down play.
Yeah, that was a big conversion. Just ran Carter right there in a soft spot. Let him turn around, throw it to him quick. Get the first down, move the chains, keep the ball.
So now from the 24-yard line, Carter and Jones are split to the left side. Jones is in motion this time.
Carter, I mean, there's Meacham.
It's almost caught. One-handed grab almost made by Carter. He was trying to fight off the defense of Lucas, Daquan Lucas. And Carter, who's made a couple of one-handed catches already tonight, almost had another one.
Yeah, almost a heck of a catch right there. But I thought he had Meacham on the crossing route. And he looked at him, and he turned and threw it to Carter. I think if he gets that ball to Meacham, that's a good 7, 8, 10-yard pickup.
Yeah, good point. So it's second and 10 from the 24. Quick pass out to the left, overshooting Carter. And it's a good thing Carter picked that up because that could have been perceived as a lateral. But it's incomplete. And that's a touch play that Kent's got to work on a little bit. It's going to be third down and 10 from the 24-yard line. 37-36 Richmond. They had a 22-point lead at the end of one quarter, 22-0. But Carolina has come storming back. Kent looking, flushed out of the pocket on the left, fires. Wide open,
yes.
Jones, touchdown.
He got a flag down. I think it's going to be illegal. Be illegal defense. I think that touchdown is going to stand, Jeff.
Somehow Jones found himself wide open. He got himself loose, and it is an illegal defense, which will be declined. The touchdown stands.
Yeah, blown coverage there by Carolina.
Big time.
Jones was wide open.
Big time touchdown pass. The second touchdown reception for Jones tonight. And just like that, Richmond has a 7-point lead. They can make it 8.
Yeah, that was a big-time play there.
So Jones with that touchdown catch of 24 yards, together with one in the first half, from the 1-yard line, he had a 49-yard touchdown reception. And so they'll take a delay of game here. That won't hurt Stevens. He's just a superb kicker. And they'll move it back 5 yards.
And you hate to see that, though, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
This is a big point right here.
Yeah, it sure is. You don't want to take it for granted, that's for sure. So this time, instead of Gallen holding, it'll be Robert Kent holding. Snap is good. Flag goes down. The kick is good. I think that flag is going to be against Carolina.
Did he make it?
Yep.
Oh, they're calling. They're saying no good.
Well, if it is
nobody gave a signal.
If it is no good, the defensive flag will give him another crack at it. And
that's a big penalty. Yeah,
yeah.
Must have been no good.
Must have been no good.
Yeah.
He's kicking again.
Absolutely.
And that's that 5 yards we talked about on the delay game. You don't want to take this for granted. Now, Stevens is a great kicker, but
he's used to it from there.
Distance,
and we got also take inside those goalposts a little bit skinnier than the traditional goalposts.
That's very true.
You know, those who are watching online and, you know, those who are listening to us, those are not your traditional goalposts. They are, they're inward a little bit. So
from the 10-yard line, it becomes really like a 17-yard extra point, 7 yards or so in the end zone. The kick is blocked. And, you know, that was a very slow snapped ball back to the holder. And the extra point fails. And the lead remains 7.
That's a big point. Let's see if we can get it back on the kickoff.
Yeah.
And so, you know, that penalty made a big difference there.
Yes, it did. So 43-36, the score remains with 9:07 to go. And so the crowd applauds the offense, but I know that they would like that extra point for that eight-point lead. Now the defense is going to have to take over. It really,
it makes a difference there. You got to realize that makes a big difference because you could have got the extra point, made it 8. Now they have to go for 2. You don't have to go for two. And if Stevens makes it here, that's a 9-point
lead.
And so that's two possessions here.
Yeah.
So let's see what Stevens does here.
If he can get this point back for us, that would be huge.
Stevens has done it twice tonight, splitting the uprights at the other end for two very valuable points.
And I think, guys, it's safe to say, you know, Carolina Energy's kicker has been very consistent, but I don't think he's got the leg to make an extra point on a field goal.
No, he does not.
So here we go. Stevens kicking off from his goal line, going left to right across your radio dial. 43-36 Richmond with 9:07 to go in the ballgame. Here's the kick, it's got a chance! Just wide right. It had the distance and just missed to the right. They'll bring it out to the 20-yard line.
It brings it out to the 20-yard line, and you got Carolina who has, you know, in the second half been doing pretty well on offense. You know, a couple of breakdowns in the secondary by Richmond and Carolina staying in this game.
Let's see what David Washington can do. He's got some talented receivers. He's been throwing it regularly to number 9, Devon Mackey, and also to Andre Dixon. But then Perry Floyd has two touchdown receptions.
Yeah, this is a big series here.
So Washington in the shotgun at the 15-yard line, looking long and incomplete. And getting behind Langster was number 2, Daniel Lee, but that pass...
I still don't like Langster giving up on that.
No, we saw that either.
Game that we called a couple weeks ago, they gave up on a play and the receiver caught up with the ball and scored.
That's right.
I don't like that. You're a corner. Don't take anything for granted. You play until the ball is in your hands or knocked to the ground.
That's a good point, Glenn.
All right, Mackey will be the receiver in motion on the far right side. Washington has Floyd blocking for him. He pump fakes. He's going to run to the left side. He's got a lot of room down the left side, and he's knocked out of bounds near the 10-yard line. But a big first down run for David Washington of Carolina. Is there a flag down?
Yes. There's a flag down right in the middle. Might be a hold.
And it is going to go against Carolina. And this will negate that first down run from Washington. And the preliminary signal might be an offensive hold. No, now they're changing their...
I didn't catch that. It sounded like it maybe inadvertent drop of the flag. I didn't catch that.
And so it looked like the preliminary signal was going to be offensive hold, but instead they're saying the flag should not have been dropped. It's first and goal from the 9-yard line. Washington, running play, and there's a hold. Probable calls on the right as Perry Floyd, no place to go. He tried to sweep the right end.
Yeah, decline that penalty.
Yeah, you decline that penalty.
Good pursuit by the left side of the defensive line.
Yeah, you don't want to hold. You don't want to take this penalty.
And so as the officials talk.
All right, I think the chains are all jacked up right now.
And it looks like they're going to take this penalty. If it's an offensive hold,
they take 10.
It's first down.
I think they're going to mark off 10 yards. It'll still be first down.
Yeah, the chains moved before Coach Zimmerman made a decision, and the referees right now are sorting out which way we can look at this. If you coach Zimmerman, I agree with you, Coach. I don't take this penalty right now.
Well, the last play was from the 10-yard line, correct?
It was from the 9, yeah.
From the 9. Okay, yeah. So the chains don't matter.
Yeah, it changed
that. So we're just looking at the down marker.
Right, you're walking it off right where the hole took place at. The hole was at the 16-yard line.
Yeah, that's
a 15-yard mark off all the way back to the 23.
Yes, I can see that.
So it's first down and goal to go. And another penalty will be called on Carolina. Illegal motion on the offensive line, and that'll cost them 5.
Yeah, the crowd is getting here, a little bit of self-destruction here by the Carolina team. And the coach is telling them to calm down, so you got like a first and goal here. It really is first and goal.
First and goal from the 18-yard line of Carolina.
Yeah, they have to score.
Yep, they sure do.
They have to score, so.
coming down to the 7.5 minute mark of the game. Washington.
Don't get beat deep.
Plenty of time to throw. Fires caught in the middle of the field. And it's Mackey spinning his way towards the 15-yard line. Now, it's still going to be goal to go, but it's a heck of a lot closer. Second and goal now from the 15.
Well, he just picked up about 15 yards.
Yeah, and that was a tough play. Richmond's got to do a better job right there. Yeah, their secondary, you got to stick on those guys. Once you get in scramble drill mode, you got to stick to them. And,
yeah.
You know, Reese Thorne was just kind of lost out there in space. He's got to lock on to that receiver and not let him catch that ball.
Yeah, you got to definitely not let him catch the ball. We under 7 minutes and now in this contest.
Mackey to the right. Dixon to the left. In motion, Lee. Washington flushed out of the pocket. Fires on the run, just throws it away.
Yeah, good job, good pressure by Hardy right there.
Yeah, good play, great Hardy, which brings up third and goal right now.
Richmond has had two standout defensive stops in the first quarter, or Carolina would have an additional 14 points.
Yeah, as we mentioned, this game is long, for being over 6 minutes and 26 seconds left in this contest. And, you know, it's a lot of football.
Third down, goal to go from the 15-yard line. Again, Mackey wide right. Lee is in the slot on the right side. And the motion player will be Dixon on the right. Washington across to Dixon. He catches it at the 5 and immediately tackled by Mike Carey. And it'll be fourth and goal from the 5.
Yeah, this is fourth and goal here. And this is a big play right here.
Injured player, Carolina. And it's Daniel Lee. Wide receiver.
Look like a cramp, yeah.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. We've seen those, haven't we, Glenn?
Yeah, we've seen those.
Hopefully it's that, not a hamstring.
Yeah, hopefully it's that.
He's trying to stretch it. Yeah. It looks like that. I'm pretty sure that's a cramp.
5:49 to go in this one. And,
you know, and what this does, it gives Carolina a timeout. It gives Richmond a timeout, too. And you know, Coach Zimmerman can cut dial up something on defense here. It's fourth down, 5:49 here. Fourth and goal from the 5-yard line. Let's see if Richmond can have another goal line stand. You know, if you're Coach Zimmerman, Coach, you're not happy with your team, your defense, tell you the truth. You know,
right.
It was fourth and 35. I mean, you know, they got 30 yards.
Yeah, 30 yards in three plays.
So the free timeout for both squads, as Lee has helped off the field, walks off basically under his own power. So a new wide receiver in for Carolina. And it's going to be this fourth and goal from the 5. And are they going to call time?
No,
they're not. So here we go from the shotgun. Washington looking right, flushed out of the pocket, fires,
yes.
Incomplete.
Greg Hardy.
Richmond has held again.
And that's a big play there by Greg Hardy.
Yep.
Big play by Greg Hardy, who got pressure on this Carolina team. Now, if you're a Richmond offense, you need to go down the field and score.
Yes, indeed. 5:36 to go. They want to take as much time off this clock as possible.
And it's a lot of time. I mean, 5:36, two scores down with about 4 minutes left. It's still a lot of score.
I tell you, Hardy is limping down there, man. That was a heck of a play down there by him.
And he gave it 110%.
Yeah, he gave it 110%.
He made a couple big-time plays on there. He pressured Washington one time on an earlier play, and then that play right there, big-time plays.
And Coach Zimmerman wanted to congratulate him on. He gave him a bear hug.
Yeah, they're about the same size.
And, you know, Glenn, back to your point about Coach Zimmerman not being happy, all that was null and void because you made the stop.
You
made a play when you had to make a play.
So here we go, 1st and 10 from the 5-yard line. Robert Kent.
Down the middle. Oh.
It's caught out of the left. Just shy of a first down, the catch was made by Damari Jones.
He had
a receiver deep.
He had Meacham down the middle of the field. I can tell you, I really like all the receiver matchups against the safeties here.
Yeah, me too.
I think we can exploit that.
If you're Richmond, you keep running. You keep this clock running. Carolina has all three timeouts left. So it's 4:47. Just want to make sure we keep aware of the timeout.
Yep.
It's 10 seconds left on this game clock. Yeah, 10 seconds left on the play clock.
7-yard gain on that pass play, 2nd and 3. It's a running play, and making it for the first down and more is the fullback, number 52, Michael Williams.
He was rumbling and stumbling down the field that time.
It wasn't pretty, but he got the first down, and he gets a great round of applause from the fans here.
Is what you go back to day one when you get any kid playing running back, whether it's every level, you tell him to keep his feet moving.
Yep.
He's kept his feet moving, and when you got a guy like that, a locomotive that's going, he's carrying everything with him until help comes.
Coach Stout is an old O-line coach. He loves the big boy love right there.
His knee went down just shy of midfield. First and 10 from the 24-and-a-half yard line.
And what you want is the first down here.
Three-step drop to the end zone. Touchdown, Robert Meacham. And just like that, Richmond's up by two scores.
That's that NFL quality right there.
Well, you look at it, you had an NFL player make a big fourth down play, and then you got another NFL player making a touchdown right there.
Yeah,
Great drive by Richmond.
Yeah, that NFL connection right there for the Richmond Rough Riders came through to play tonight. If I was interviewing Coach Zimmerman, that's what I would say.
Yeah, no doubt.
Your two NFL players late in the game helped you overcome where you was at.
Yep.
The fourth touchdown pass of the night for Robert Kent came at a perfect time with 3:17 to go, and it puts Richmond up by 13, and this one would make it 14. Stevens.
And there's still a lot of time left.
Yep. Another delay.
Oh. Oh, my. That happened last time, and it cost them the extra point.
We don't see that much from Richmond. I don't remember. I think this is the first two delayed games on kickoff that I've seen all year at Richmond.
So Jeremy made a little extra celebrating there in the end zone after the touchdown.
Yeah, that hurt.
So it took a little longer for
the now the fans are serenading. Maybe a bit early, but
it's too early for that.
Yep.
It is.
Gallon to hold from the 14 high snap. He puts it down. And Stevens' kick is good. So Richmond takes a 14-point lead with 3:07 to go in the game, 50-36.
I don't know if you guys picked that up. You might want to check it out on a replay and watch it over again. But if you watch the center on this play, he snaps, and there was an open lineman. He puts him to the carpet.
Oh, wow.
He puts him to the carpet so they could not be a block or get his big hands up like he did on the previous play to block the extra point.
Great job seeing that. You know, going back to the touchdown, I really think exploiting those safeties is something, you know. You get a guy like Robert Meacham or any of the receivers we have, and they can really, you give them a two-way go with that safety where they can run the post or they can run a corner route.
And that's what he did. He ran, about to say the same thing, Coach. Yeah. He ran a post corner, safety bit on the inside, and hit the corner, put his foot in the dirt, hit the corner.
Now, guys, I want to... Talking to two coaches here, in arena football, is there such a thing, or would you employ some kind of prevent defense here?
Nah, it's 50 yards. Play what you normally play. It's not a prevent. You can't do a prevent. I
don't think they're allowed to be honest with you. They've got a guy to have five guys in the box.
Okay.
I don't think you're allowed to play anything like that.
Okay.
And that makes the league fun,
yeah.
I think.
And I'm not a fan of prevent defense anyway, because prevent defense didn't get me there.
Yeah, that's a good point.
I'm not a big fan of that.
And the extra point attempt by Stevens just falls shy.
You know, if it worked for you for 4.5 quarters, let's not change in the last minute. You may drop your quarters back, your corners back, your safeties back.
Well,
you know.
And if it's the last play of the game, you might want to do that last, you know, 20 seconds. But you can score so quickly in this league.
Yeah.
Definitely at 3 minutes, you don't want to think about that yet.
Nah. You right now, if you're Carolina and you're Carolina's coach, what you want to do is you say, yeah, we got 3 minutes. Let's score as quick as we can, and let's try to do something, try to stop them, because I still have all three of my timeouts left.
Yeah.
And that's what you're looking for as a coach. Hey, we've been down here. Let's score, and let's keep it going.
All right. Well, the three-man defensive front led by Greg Hardy in there to stop Washington, and they put pressure on him, and they force an incompletion. He had to hurry on a pass to Dixon. Dixon had it in his hands. He couldn't corral it, though.
And that's that defensive line, that all-star defensive line, getting pressure when it counts
at the end
of the game.
Yeah, that's a good point, that all-star defensive line getting pressure. Yes. And great coverage in the secondary that time. These guys, they've had a little bit rough here in parts of this game, but that was great coverage, and they've done a pretty good job here in the fourth quarter.
Clock ticks down to 2:18. Deontay Hollis, the defensive end, on the left. Greg Hardy on the right. Darren Link in the middle, putting pressure hopefully on Washington, and the pass out is caught for a first down. Mackey retreats for 2 yards. He'll still get credit for a first down as he almost ran too far in the back.
Yeah, he didn't. He turned around and didn't turn out. Just get what he get at this point. Get what you can get and keep it moving.
Yeah, good job by Mackey, just finding a soft spot over there, and you know, good pass by Washington to get it over top of Thorne's head and into the receiver's hands.
Yeah, we got you know, under 2 minutes left here, and if you're Carolina now, the clock is starting to work against you.
Yeah, you got two scores to get a tie, and Washington snapped to him, fires it to the left, almost a great catch at the 7 yard line by Mackey. The pass was just
was
a little too far.
Let me ask you a question. I don't know the rule on this. If that ball is in the stands like that, can one of the stands, can one of the fans hit?
Fans can hit it, but it becomes interference on the fans, incomplete. But the player can go over bounds and catch it.
Gotcha. So he went over bounds to catch that one.
Yeah, he can go over bounds and catch that, out of bounds and catch it. Over the wall for those who are watching on YouTube.
The clock stops with the 1 minute warning, and there'll be a timeout here. And it would be one thing if Carolina was only down by 7, but they're down by 14. They need two scores. They need a quick touchdown and an onside kick.
If you're Carolina here, you want to score as quick as possible. So you got about 3 shots here to the end zone. If you Carolina, if you Richmond, hey, just tackle everything in front of you.
Yep.
Everything. You're telling your guys right now, we have two friends. We have the school board and the clock. So tackle everything in front of you, and we get out here with a W. We're in the championship game, as they like to call it now. We're in the ship next week.
That's right.
Okay, with 1 minute to go, and the clock stops at every possession inside of a minute. But Carolina does have all three of its timeouts. From the 19, Washington in the shotgun. Lofts it to the right end zone. Tucked it up at the last second. Langster does a great job at the very last second in breaking up the pass that was intended for Dixon.
Yeah, big play right there by Ellis Langster. Good break on the ball. Great job to knock it away.
Yeah, very good play there. We're down to 55 seconds now. All three timeout. No need timeout. Coach is telling the offense to hurry up. Let's get to the line. Let's hurry up and see what we can get here. And this crowd is letting them know.
The crowd is getting into it, putting a lot of noise into this building as Washington in the shotgun at midfield fires it out to the left. It's caught by Dixon. He makes one guy miss. He gets inside the 10-yard line. He goes down at about the 9 or 8.
And we don't have a timeout, but the clock already stopped anyway because it's first down.
Yeah, I think if Thorne breaks down right there and just keeps that to a 6-7 yard gain instead of trying to get out there and make that pass break up, now, he slipped that tackle from Thorne and ended up picking up the first down.
I don't know. Carolina's coach here. He tried to say.
First and goal from the 8. Washington looking right. Now runs up in the pocket. He almost is sacked. Now he rushes to the right, and he's going to keep it on the ground. He's still on his feet inside the 5, and he's tackled finally down at the 3.
And it's 23 seconds here.
That was a great individual effort right there, but it took, what, 15 seconds?
15 seconds.
Just put the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, so now you have to score. And I understand Coach Carolina, for the Carolina Indians, he doesn't want to use his timeouts on this possession. He's hoping we score.
Right, yeah he's going to need them.
He's going to need them. He's hoping we score. And then Richmond takes the timeout.
Yeah. 23 seconds to go. Richmond timeout. Coach Zimmerman will huddle the team.
And that's not a bad timeout by Coach Zimmerman. Look. Take your time. I'll let you guys rest. Understand. Explain the situation to them and tell them what's going on. We got 23 seconds. If they score, it's okay. We're fine. We're fine.
Yeah, I agree. I tell you, Hardy's a warrior out there, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a warrior out there. He's thinking about that hydro chamber, maybe cryo down the street, get some frozen up a little bit. But he is a warrior.
50-36, Richmond leads by 14.
I don't care what anybody says.
Carolina has it on the 5-yard line. It's 23 seconds to go in the ball game.
It's nothing like
Washington
playing
the from the
game.
10-yard line in the shotgun. In motion is Perry. It's a pass for a tackle eligible, and it's a score. And making the reception, number 65, Christopher Kane, a well-designed play.
A little bit of Richmond's own medicine right there.
I'm afraid so. But it comes with only 19 seconds. They're going to need an extra point. They're going to need an onside kick.
Yeah, it's 42-50 here, 19 seconds. If you're Richmond, want your hands teamed out there. Get your hands teamed right now. You're telling everybody to get your hands teamed. Once you get your hands teamed together and they get the ball, this game is over.
Yeah, it should be.
They're going to take a timeout. So they'll take one of their three.
That is not, that's not, you take the delay of penalty there. And the reason, and this is why you take the delay of penalty.
Yeah,
you
back not it, a good timeout.
That's not a good timeout. You back it up because you need all three timeouts
right.
when Richmond goes on offense.
You're right. That's a terrible,
that's
terrible
a terrible time. Yeah, terrible pair with
yeah.
penalty right there.
And that kills your game right here unless that, you get the onside kick.
Unless you get the onside kick, that kills your ball game. I'm sorry. I take the penalty. I don't know what coach is thinking. We take the penalty there. We back them up.
You know, that's one of the things with me. I am so reluctant to use timeouts in the second half for anything
yeah.
other than clock issues late in the game. That's what you need, those timeouts late in the game.
Yep.
All right. Carolina trying to make it a seven-point game. High snap. Dixon gets it down, and the kick is good. So with no time going off on that extra point attempt, because it's under 1 minute, there'll still be 19 seconds to go as Carolina prepares to kick off.
Yeah, and it's 50 to 43.
And we know it'll be an onside kick, and Richmond will have their best hands team out there on that front line. I think we've seen one onside kick so far this year.
We've seen one, the game that you wouldn't hear, May 20, the May 20
yeah,
game.
We've
seen an onside kick that game.
Okay. Well, there was a few of them.
It was a few
of them.
It was like two offside kicks that game, and Richmond recovered both of them.
Okay. So they have some practice at it.
Yeah, had some practice at it.
All right, Gallen will go deep as if he were going to get the ball, but I think all seven other players, or as many as they can, will be on that front line.
And what you're looking for here, and then you got different people do different onside kicks, but I think here you're looking for a high bounce.
Yeah, you got too many out there. We got nine out there now. We need one off.
Yeah, somebody has to come
one,
off.
Two, three.
You're right. And coming off will be Mike Carey.
I'm not sure I'd take Carey off.
Yeah, Carey wouldn't be the one I'd take off on this.
Now, you haven't seen Daniel Barnes in the game at all, and he is in there for this.
Yeah,
I think I would have had Carey in there, too.
They are very confused right now.
So you have somebody who has not played the whole game in there.
Yeah, but, you know, you with this with hands team, this guy, he knows your assignment. You know, you put this in, you know your assignment. It's something that we go over on Thursday practice, run through all these situations.
Yeah.
Yep.
So Robert Meacham, Rashad Carter, Damari Jones, Malik Johnson.
And the kicker has the ball sideways, so this is looking for a bounce here.
Here's the kick, and it goes to Carter, who goes right down.
There's your ball game.
And this secures the win for Richmond. They advance to next week's finals.
Yeah,
America
Arena. Still got 17 seconds.
Yeah, we still have 17 seconds, but with only two timeouts.
They can take a knee.
But let me ask you a question. Isn't there a rule in arena ball where if you don't make positive play gain, the clock stops? I remember
that.
The clock stops.
You got to have a positive gain.
We may be a little premature right
now.
You got to have some positive gain here.
I'll
tell you what I would do, Glenn. I wouldn't run the ball. I would drop back and throw the ball three times out of the end zone. That's going to – if you do that four times, the clock's going to run out.
Yeah, I'll make them chase me a little bit.
Yeah, I wouldn't run the ball.
Make them chase you a little bit.
You know, you got to have confidence in Kent not to throw an interception, but at the same time – 10 yards out of bounds.
It's going to be a quarterback keeper, and it's inside the 10, down to the 8. A quick timeout with 11 seconds to go. That's their second timeout.
So that took, what, 6 seconds?
Yep.
So Robert Kent will get up and probably, based on that, do that again. But I kind of like the idea of just throwing it out because –
Yeah, but we saw Kent throw an interception earlier.
Yeah, you're right.
So you're leery, and I know offensive coordinators, they want the ball, and I know I'm screaming at the offense, go run the ball. Run the ball. Let's get out of here. Run the ball.
And Kent's going to, oh, man, I got a wide-open receiver. I know Coach told me to throw it out of bounds or out of the end zone.
Yeah.
I'm going to go for this touchdown right here.
And the worst thing can happen, get a pick six the other direction.
You're right.
The nose guard is going to be right in the face of that center, trying to get him to mess up the snap to Robert Kemp. From the 9, go down. Oh, he's going to go for a touchdown. How about that? Robert Kent. Everybody was trying to draw the bar loose, and Robert Kent on a quarterback keeper, 9 yards for a touchdown.
Yeah, I think Carolina's only hope was to try to strip that ball right there, and Kent refused to go down and end up going around the right side for the touchdown on the quarterback sneak.
We got 5 seconds left on that one, so.
So the win by Richmond will become a little more respectable in the sense that it's now a 13-point lead, maybe a 14 should Stevens make this extra point. 5 seconds to go in the game. Gallon to hold, good snap, good hold, and the kick is perfect. So Richmond now officially is 5 seconds away. Oh, we have an injured player.
And that's what you don't want to have happen.
Yeah, number 55, Walton is.
Yeah, and what you tell Stevens now, put that ball on the ground, squib kick that, let's get out of here.
I like him to kick it through the end zone.
Yeah, well, the clock doesn't stop. It doesn't start to the end zone. Let's put this on the ground, end zone.
Yeah, even if they return it back, hopefully that'll be 5 seconds.
Yeah.
Well, a well-deserved victory for Richmond, just 5 seconds away, as they bent, but they didn't break. I mean, they had a 22-0 lead after one, and they saw Carolina come back to tie it at the half and even take the lead on the opening kickoff of the third quarter. And they came back from being down by 7 and regained their momentum. And 4 touchdown passes by Robert Kent and a rushing touchdown as well. And Richmond is 5 seconds away from advancing to the finals.
And Jeff, they were in a dogfight tonight, but that's what championship teams do. They find a way to win. And championship franchises bring in players to make plays.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Big-time players make big-time plays.
Make big-time plays.
Big-time situations.
That's right.
And big-time players, both of those, you know, Meacham is a Super Bowl champion, you know, with the New Orleans Saints.
Oh, that's right.
With the New Orleans Saints. And Greg Hardy's played in some big, meaningful playoff games with Carolina and the Dallas Cowboys. So.
Yeah. Well, here we go with Stevens preparing to kick off here.
You know, with the New Orleans Saints, Greg Hardy played in some big, meaningful playoff games.
Yeah.
With Carolina and the Dallas Cowboys.
Kick this.
So,
yeah. Well, here we go with Stevens preparing to kick off here.
Winner.
the Atlanta Havocs and the Cape Fear squad out of North Carolina.
Yeah, we got an update right now. The Havocs are up 36-26 over the Heroes.
Third quarter.
Yep, all right.
Thomas of WKT Radio, hopefully, Jeff Bummer, wishing you all a very pleasant good evening.